highest law enforcement officer in the state. That's definitely something good. The men and women of ICE here in Boston are really proud to have Andy and his staff on our side.
Well, his one of his grand juries did indict a sitting judge in the Newton District Court for letting an illegal alien go while one of your men was waiting outside to collar him, you know, so he's serious about this. Let me read a little more of this. Meanwhile, our residents fall victim to violent crimes committed by people who, if there was a secure border and better cooperation with immigration authorities, wouldn't be here at all. In 2017, a man previously deported for drug and gun crimes, but now illegally back in the United States, raped a Boston College student while working as an Uber driver. Despite knowing his immigration status, a judge in Newton gave him bail and local authorities released him. That was not the judge. That was a different judge than the one who's under indictment now. No one notified ICE. That was Judge Heffernan. He fled the country, and that young woman has yet to see justice done. In 2018, a previously deported Salvadorian national slashed a woman's throat in a town near Boston. Local police knew he was here illegally, but never notified ICE. Luckily, the U.S. Marshals did, and the man was arrested in Maryland. I mean, how is this helping anyone? They always talk, well, we have to have better police relations with them.
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
I plan on trying to win New Hampshire. I'm not here to come in second.
Both Elizabeth Warren and Joe Biden will not meet that 15% threshold. And as a result, they will be shut out of pledged delegates in the state of New Hampshire tonight.
We're going to be back in New Hampshire. We're going to be back there to defeat Donald Trump in November.
Nobody under 10% at this point in the process has ever went on to win the nomination and has ever really been, you know, competitive at the end.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
So something has happened in the last 48 hours. People have told me that they're giving Amy Klobuchar a second look.
I wonder why.
I am not going to sugarcoat it. We took a gut punch in Iowa.
You're a lying dog-faced pony soldier.
You cannot have 20, 30, 40, 50 clips in a weapon.
Are you concerned about the message that you're sending to New Hampshire by going to South Carolina?
Not at all.
And why are you so negative?
I'm not getting up on New Hampshire. Don't poke out in my face, okay, buddy?
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
You know, we're counting on having the wind of New Hampshire at our backs. I've got a reservation to fly on to South Carolina tomorrow afternoon.
I am so sorry. That flight is canceled.
Former Massachusetts Governor Deval Patrick is expected to suspend his campaign.
And Diane and I are going to go home and rest and reflect on this outcome.
We're going to be fine.
You know, I am the math guy. And it is clear tonight from the numbers that we are not going to win this race. I am suspending my campaign for president.
Unchained and unstoppable.
President Trump last night had the highest voter turnout of any incumbent in four decades. He also had the highest percent of the vote of any incumbent in the past four decades. The enthusiasm's on President Trump's side. Democrats, by the way, have a dumpster fire.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
My heart feels like an alligator. I stayed up till 1 o'clock, even though the results were already in. I was just reveling in it. It was hilarious. And they were basically having meltdowns or trying to, pretend that they weren't having meltdowns. Van Jones, you know, the communist that works for CNN, he was saying how depressed the Democrats are, how depressed everyone is looking at this race that's unfolding. Are you depressed? I'm elated. I think things are going splendidly. Everything is falling into place. This is great stuff. You know, I mean, Elizabeth Warren has pulled all of her advertising out, TV advertising in Nevada and South Carolina. She's doing so well. Many of her supporters decided not to vote for her in the end because they had reservations. I'm just reading the stuff that's the jokes that are coming in over the text line. Deval Patrick's vote percentage came up short.
Ha 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 ha!
And now that it's curtains for his campaign. Remember curtains, when he bought the curtains for the corner office? That's going back a ways now. Maybe some people have forgotten that, but 603 hadn't forgotten it. All right. So it's great. There's a lot to talk about again today. And as you know, President Trump got more votes than probably any incumbent president running in the New Hampshire primary ever. Bernie won, but he won with a lot fewer votes and a lot smaller percentage of the votes than last time. It looks like the revolution is on hold for a while. And now you have Buttigieg was close behind him, and behind him was Amy Klobuchar, the worst boss on Capitol Hill. I pull that story again today. There've been a lot of stories about her over the years. The most famous being that in 2008, she was flying to South Carolina, and her aide brought her, she wanted a salad on the plane. So the aide brought her the salad, and they had forgotten to include any utensils, and there weren't any utensils on the plane. So she was in a rage. And she ate the salad with her comb. And when she finished the salad, she threw a comb at the aide and told the aide to clean the comb so that she could use it again. This is her temper. I mean, think about that. 535 people in Congress of every stripe. And she's probably the worst boss out of the 535 of them. And she's one of these people that sends out emails berating her staff with all capital letters and threatening to fire them between 1 and 4 in the morning. Now, you know, I have my suspicions about people that are sending out emails with all caps at between 1 and 4 in the morning, and I'm sure they're the same suspicions you have, but I can't, I don't know. I can't prove anything. So they are in a total state of disbelief about what is happening here. And it looks like Bloomberg is trying to, get through this whole thing with the stop and frisk controversy. And it's not so much the stop and frisk, because I think most reasonable people agree that stop and frisk did reduce crime and that it was a good idea. What's really going to hurt Bloomberg is just his imperious attitude and the fact that he's talking about how, you can just send out a Xerox of every young black male, and it's all the same. And what's the worst of all is sometimes you just need to throw them up against the wall. Wow. Can you imagine if a Republican said that? Can you imagine if Donald Trump said something, it was on tape saying something like that? And they just got to, and you know, the thing is though, the mainstream media is so unbelievably corrupt. There's a woman named Christina Alessi, and she used to work for Bloomberg. And I guess, you know, when Bloomberg buys somebody, they stay bought. So yesterday, she was one of several people who were saying, oh, you know, this, you know, they've just, these are Bernie bros, and they've just taken some random cuts and spliced them together. And it's just not true. But it's all BS. But here it is. This is more of the corruption. And that's what it is. It's the corruption of CNN in particular and the mainstream media in general. Cut 32.
She's important lying. Context here. We don't have the full tape. So this is obviously snippets that have been released. The podcaster and the writer that released this sound is clearly a Bernie supporter. If you look at his Twitter feed, he's very anti-Bloomberg. He is promoting a hashtag, Bloomberg is a racist. We don't know how he got the sound to begin with. Lots of questions are being asked, especially on the timing of this. As you noted in your introduction, a poll yesterday shows Bloomberg rising in the polls and particularly strong support in the African-American community. He polled at 22%, just behind Joe Biden at 27%.
We don't know how he got it. Maybe he Googled it. That's how you can get it. If you want it right now, you can just Google it and it just comes right up. But I got to play, before we go to the break, and we're going to take a lot of calls, I have to play you Katie Turr. And we'll go, I think at some point during the day, we're going to go through Katie Turr's greatest hits. This is Keith Olbermann's former girlfriend. And she really has outpaced Brooke Baldwin, thank goodness, as the dumbest of the female anchors on the alt-left stations. This is really dumb. She's with Chris Sununu walking around with him, and she's talking, and he's trying to tell her about how great the economy is. So this is Katie Turr from MSNBC.
Ask people if they're voting for Donald Trump. I hear about the 401k is a lot. That's a number I hear. 401k. My 401k is doing great. But there are those out there who don't have a 401k. And there are those out there who this economy is not really working for. They might have a job, but it's not a job that pays their bills. They can get a car, but it's a loan that'll last them 30 years. They can't buy a house. The economy's not working in a way that makes their lives function properly.
Well, you're spinning that message in a state with the lowest poverty rate in the country. We've made it lower. One of the lowest unemployment rates. We have more jobs and families moving into New Hampshire than ever before, more working people than ever before.
I don't know why Chris didn't just call us. You have a 30-year loan on your car? Really, Katie? That's a new one on me. A lot of people have 30-year mortgages, but not too many people have 30-year loans on their car. How dumb is she? And this was just earlier. I think it was just earlier this month. And, you know, we're not even halfway through February yet. She was talking about how they needed to gerrymander the Senate, cut 28. Okay, we're coming up here. We'll get it. Hold on. Guess we're having a problem.
Is gerrymandering something that would help improve the situation? How does that sort of divide promote consensus in the Senate or even in the House?
Well, I mean, they're the only resolution. Gerrymandering's not going to do anything because in the Senate, we're talking about states, right? Yeah. You can't gerrymander states. The only solution is for Democrats to appeal to voters in those states, right?
She wants to how do you gerrymander the Senate? Good Lord. 844-500-4242. That is that's the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. 860 says, how about some kind of death pool for the Pocahontas campaign? Whoever guesses closest to the day she suspends wins. Let's face it, her goose is cooked and I couldn't be happy. You know, the thing is, you know what I want to say? I want to say that everyone should say a prayer for Bailey, the dog. And I'm not the first person who came up with this. This is the guy in the Globe message board today said, he's very, very concerned about Bailey, you know, because she's been using Bailey as a campaign prop. And now the campaign, as the texter says, is coming to an end. So, you know, under these kinds of circumstances, this is when, you know, parents tell their kids, you know, what happened to Bailey, Daddy? Bailey went to the farm.
Were you Whitey Bulger?
You've never heard of people sending their dogs to the farm, Taylor?
Your father's not coming home for Christmas.
Bailey's not coming home. Kid. She doesn't need Bailey. So this person on the Globe message board said we need to do the hashtag save Bailey. Save Bailey. Say a prayer for Bailey. This could be a treacherous time for him. You know, now that his mistress is fading away, she's run out of money. She's canceling all the TV spot buys in the next two states, Nevada and South Carolina.
I feel bad for Elizabeth Warren's husband. He's going to run out of excuses to leave the house.
Did you see what Trump tweeted back? Said, I get the feeling she's sending signals. She wants to leave and go back and have a nice cold beer with her husband. She wants to get her a beer. 844-500-4242.
I'm going to get me a beer.
Someone says, isn't Bloomberg's comment factual? Do you think we should have to throw people up against the wall? I'm not in favor of throwing people up against the wall. I wonder what would happen if a Republican said that. 844-500-4242. Someone says Bailey went out to get himself a beer. Don't come back, Bailey. Make a run for it. I'm Howie Carr.
If you change the station, the Moonbats win. You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Nauset Beach Inn. From May 1st to June 19th, get an ocean view room at half price, only $150. Go to NausetBeachInn.com and click special offers. That's NausetBeachInn.com.
The 2020 elections have the potential to shape the next decade financially. That's especially true if you're within 10 years of retirement. Is your plan ready? Find out with a portfolio stress test from Kevin Frisbee at Frisbee & Associates. Call 800-989-9100 for your no-cost, no-obligation analysis. Kevin can help uncover any hidden fees that may be lurking in your plan. The team at Frisbee & Associates are up to date on all the latest rules and regulations from what the SECURE Act is and isn't to Social Security and Medicare. Let Kevin and the team give you peace of mind as you
get your
retirement. Make sure your plan is ready.
Taylor, I don't have anything on November. The cheap bastard deal. Do you have something for me, or can you just send it to me?
Just
send me something real quick, and I can just read it on the computer.
Howie Carr Radio
email it to
every
me.
Every Thursday at 3:50 as he reviews the market.
Grace is going to send it
now at 800-989-9100.
Sorry about the lag in the clips. The mailroom manager and Grace are playing a prank on me.
A prank on you?
Yes.
Well, it's coming back on me.
An interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
How did you come up with the name VB?
My first producer and I both had steady girlfriends, or we were married or whatever. And VB was always saying that we were whipped. You know what I mean? Finally, I said, you don't even have a girlfriend. I've never seen you with a female. As a matter of fact, I don't think you have ever had sex. You are just a virgin boy.
What is your biggest fear?
That Donald Trump will not be reelected in 2020, and that some horrible Democrat will come in and finish off the destruction of this once great country.
Out of all of your daughters, who is the least like you and why?
Probably Charlotte, though we went to the same high school, Deerfield Academy.
Katie Couric's dad
has a different sense of her responsibilities than I do. Let me put it that way. She has a different regard
for name
money.
Is Zoe.
She's not a cheap bastard.
Oh, he's the trans,
how it works,
right?
My retirement accounts.
Yeah.
And I'll bet yours, too. If your
401k,
your SEP,
someone
IRA,
just texted
whatever,
that you used to work with her in the New York station.
Right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
He is the youngest senator that is going to be running. In his video, he also mentioned he's the only senator that lives in the inner city, and he's an unmarried vegan. So a lot of very unique qualities Cory Booker brings to the table, Kate.
Now, I appreciate the comments of my colleagues. This is about the closest I'll probably ever have in my life to an I am Spartacus moment. I am Spartacus. I am Spartacus.
Joey, you like movies about gladiators.
Have you ever had an LGBTQ law clerk?
I've not been a judge, so I don't have any law clerks.
I'm working for you.
I'm to be honest, I don't know the sexual orientation of my staff.
When Dick Durbin called me, I had tears of rage when I heard about this experience in that meeting. And for you not to feel that hurt, tears of rage.
Would you just stop being so dramatic?
I'm a big believer that if this country hasn't broken your heart, then you don't love her enough.
This is Chris in Rochester, Mass.
This is Mark in Nashville, New Hampshire.
This is Lorna in Truckstown, Pennsylvania. And this is the Howie Carr Show.
All right, Valentine's Day is coming up, so we have an alternative to flowers if you want to go in a different direction. Can't go wrong with flowers, but you can't go wrong with this new cheap bastard deal we're about to offer you.
It's Howie Carr's cheap bastard deal.
Oh, yeah.
Sounds too good to be true.
Oh, no, it's real, and it's a steal.
You know there's plenty more when you shop at Howie's store for another Howie Carr cheap bastard deal.
Howie Carr, the cheapest bastard around.
Our listeners have been asking for cheap bastard deals in their areas, and today we're going to offer a deal in the Seacoast region of New Hampshire. I mean, you can use it from anywhere, but it's this Body Rituals is in Dover, New Hampshire. So this is available to anybody, and it's a great Valentine's Day gift. It's a $135 gift certificates that you can buy for half price, which is $67.50. And this gift certificate is good for a 90-minute massage with a CBD oil or towards other services. And the Body Rituals is owned by Rachel. And Rachel is on the line with us. Rachel, thanks for being with us from Body Rituals in Dover, New Hampshire. What do people get with the massage?
Well, we're really proud of the fact that each one of our therapists kind of brings their own touch, their own twist. We all kind of have a different wheelhouse. So when we book somebody with an appointment, we kind of try and find what they want to feel on the table, but also how they want to feel after their massage. And depending upon what they're looking for is who we decide to book them with. So each person is going to get something very individual and very different.
And I'm reading your the copy here. Your specialty is meeting the individual's needs of each client using a mix of classic and alternative techniques, advanced massage, energy practices, light touch, deep muscle manipulation therapies to provide each client with a therapeutic and holistic experience that exceeds general expectations for massage and body work. So, and you use the CBD oil. I have some CBD oil. It really is good. I mean, I don't know if it, you know, what it involves or, and, you know, I know there's no THC in it, but it does make my skin feel better when I put the oil on.
Absolutely. Well, and the CBD does a couple things. It helps with reducing things on a chemical level, but it also is great for anti-inflammatory purposes. Mm-hmm. We use the CBD clinic line is what we have in store. So that has other things incorporated with it, not just the CBD, but it also has menthol. It has essential oils. So it's a really well-rounded product to use on the skin.
And if you go to HowieCarrShow.com and go onto the store and you order it today, the gift certificate will go out tomorrow. Depending on where you live, it'll definitely be there, but you can print something out right off the website and you can give it to your sweetheart or your Valentine and tell her that you've gotten or your mail. You can get it's for males as well.
Hey, Howie.
Yes.
I've been really stressed out with climate change and stuff like that, and I was wondering if we could get some trade with Body Rituals because I could very much use a massage. I have a very stressful life.
What does Jane Fonda say? What's that disease that people have now, young people?
Exterminations and extinction something. I need a massage itis. I need a CBD massage itis, please.
Okay. You need
it's
one,
very
right?
Serious.
Okay. Well, you can, like I said, you can go to, we've only got a limited number available. If you want, if your girlfriend likes massages, this is a good chance to get a half price massage, $135 gift certificate for $67.50. Go to HowieCarrShow.com, click on store. Thank you, Rachel. And please take care of Grace. She needs a massage. She has extinction disorder or malady or something. I'm Howie Carr.
Around this time of year, people often say to us, "Hey, Matthews Brothers, happy birthday. You look great for your age, and how the heck does a company stay in business for so long anyway?" We usually respond by paraphrasing Joe Biden and say, two words, do your job. It takes a lot of people to produce our wicked awesome made windows, and not all of us are on the production line. We have people paying bills and collecting bills, people ordering material and counting material, salespeople on the road and salespeople in the office, people maintaining the computer network that keeps us all running, and even people making stupid radio commercials. And the reason we have so many people is because there are so many jobs to do. And without each and every one of these people doing their job, the windows don't get made. Okay, we could probably do it without this stupid radio commercial guy, but not the rest. You can see the wicked awesome made results of our teamwork, but only at Better Lumber Yards and Window Professionals or on the web at MatthewsBrothers.com. Matthews Brothers with one T, America's oldest window manufacturer.
And now, 1 minute of Nancy Pelosi.
It is a bill that is much needed for our farmers and ranchers. I think there are only 47 votes against it in the House of Representatives. The American people should know the source of it. Again, we are engaged in the year-end continuing resolution, Homeland Security. I'm not sure. No, I haven't spoken to him since he called the other day, which was a very amicable conversation. Amiable, I guess you would say, not amicable. And I talked to Chuck last night to say, you know, we haven't had an answer. There are other things that are going on that are newsworthy. And I think I think you'd have more viewers or readers if addressed concerns that people have. The list goes on about the
I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. Dr. Houghton, tell us about the state-of-the-art procedures that can help many people look 10 to 15 years younger.
As we age, we do lose these proper proportions to our faces. And so if you're deficient in your chin or mid-face, we can create the proper proportions and make you look great. Sometimes we use orthodontics to change the look of the face. Sometimes we just use the teeth themselves, and it creates the right support for a beautiful face. They're all non-surgical procedures.
There's some pretty complex cases that you deal with. Give me an example of a tough case.
Well, some cases, people just are missing a lot of teeth. I get a lot of people that come in and think that I cannot solve their problems because they're too great, but I really can. We've been doing this for over 35 years, and there isn't much that we haven't seen.
So even if you're missing a few teeth, or your teeth are discolored, or you're very embarrassed, there's no reason not to come in for a consultation, right?
Absolutely. New techniques, new technology, things are available to us that we never had before, and we can handle just about everything.
Where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE.
And now, another minute of Madam Speaker, Nancy Pelosi.
But again, you
have these wings, AOC and her group on one side.
That's like five people. They would say, play games, and then they'd say, open sesame, except we don't say sesame, we say open Biden. But no, I because the we are not. We have no, the number is growing. We have 91 women. There are 115 women in Congress, 116. 15 are Republican, 91 are Democrats. I happen to be a manifestation of the women power that is coming forth now, but only one manifestation. It was like getting kicked in the back by a mule constantly. It was physical. It was so unbelievable. The Times found Lincoln. Not to be presumptuous to put ourselves in those categories, but the Times have found us.
The word that's helping Elizabeth Warren get through her so-so campaign? So.
Will you raise taxes on the middle class to pay for it? Yes or no?
So the way I see this, so understand, taxing income is not going to get you where you need to be the way taxing wealth does.
So no, and I'm not here to criticize other Democrats.
So my proposal is that student loan debt would be canceled up to $50,000.
So, Elizabeth, can you put this issue to bed and tell us whether or not you are, in fact, a member of a minority group?
So, middle-class families.
Why did you list yourself as an American Indian on this Texas FAR application?
So, I grew up out in Oklahoma. So, look.
Why did you check those boxes?
So.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios,
And I want to thank, if you look at what happened, I want to thank the Justice Department for seeing this horrible thing. And I didn't speak to him, by the way, just so you understand. They saw the horribleness of a 9-year sentence for doing nothing. You have murderers and drug addicts, they don't get 9 years. 9 years for doing something that nobody even can define what he did. Somebody said he put out a tweet, and the tweet, you based it on that. We have killers, we have murderers all over the place, nothing happens. And then they put a man in jail and destroy his life, his family, his wife, his children. 9 years in jail, it's a disgrace. In the meantime.
That's President Trump talking about Roger Stone and the fact that these angry Democrat prosecutors left over from the Mueller team, at least two of them, two out of the four, wanted a 7 to 9 year sentence. The guy tweeted something out or texted somebody, and he said, I'm going to get your therapy dog or something like that. I mean, this was just like locker room talk. The guy the idiot that he was texting with, it was just somebody he'd known for 100 years in New York. And he admitted that he felt no threat. No physical threat. And they said, this will be a good demonstration, a way to discourage, potential future offenders. You know, it's absurd. He was charged with lying to Congress. Wait, how many years does Brennan get if lying to Congress is now a crime? Does he get about 150 years? How about Clapper? He lied to Congress. Does he get 200 years? How about Comey? Do you think he really didn't remember 240 times? Let's give him 500 years. They're going to give Roger Stone 7 to 9 years. And the thing is, there's no underlying crime here. They were asking him about the Russia probe. There was no Russian collusion. So they want to give him 7 to 9 years. We'll get more on that. You talk about a malpractice in the media, forget the DOJ. Here's the headline in Politico. Trump's attack on his own DOJ prosecutors. These were the guys who tried to put him in jail. They're not his own DOJ prosecutors. And Politico knows it. Time magazine, extraordinary step. The extraordinary step was trying to give 7 to 9 years to this guy who's 67 years old, who's now bankrupt with all of his legal fees for doing nothing, absolutely nothing. Politico, the extraordinary exit and the extraordinary events. And then they had the liberal hack who went up to Senator Martha McSally, and she called him a liberal hack from CNN. He's going around to the senator, the Republican senators, as they're coming into the Senate chambers for a vote this morning. And he's asking, do you think there should be another investigation of Trump's interference? Trump can pardon Roger Stone. He didn't, you know, you just heard him say he didn't interfere. And you know, what does it matter? He can pardon the guy. And I hope he does. I hope he does it. And then the stories on the radio I heard about an hour ago, President Trump could be dangling pardons. He has the right to pardon or commute anybody he wants, the sentence of anybody he wants. It's just outrageous. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company that I trust. Give them a call to get a free, no obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. Last night was the Westminster dog show, the Westminster Kennel Club dog show in New York. And it came down to to the last two dogs were a golden retriever named Daniel and a poodle, standard French poodle named Siba, and the crowd was in the corner of the golden retriever. It was a bad night for golden retrievers, though. You know, Bailey. Somebody says Bailey. The hashtag should be prayers for Bailey. Another one says you and the mailroom manager should adopt Bailey. No, Gunnar doesn't want a Democrat dog coming into the House. I'm telling you, we're not taking him. But anyway, the poll question concerns what happened at the dog show last night. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Which dog would you have voted for to win the Westminster Dog Show? Seba, the standard poodle, or Daniel, the golden retriever?
I'm a poodle guy. I'm a poodle boy. I used to have a standard poodle by the name of Princess way, way, way back when. This is for you, Princess. Go Seba.
Didn't Whitey have a couple of poodles too?
He did. He had two miniature black poodles. I had a miniature black poodle by the name of Frisky. So I had a miniature at a standard French poodle. They were good dogs, really good dogs.
Seba, the standard poodle, is coming in at about, it was polling higher than Elizabeth Warren did yesterday, 13%.
Really? I thought Seba would do better than that. I figured it'd come in around 20, 30%.
No, Daniel's got 87% of the popular vote.
I'll bet if it were Daniel versus Bailey, Daniel would win too, you know? I don't think people, you know, Bailey can't help who his owner is, but, you know, I'm again, prayers for Bailey or save Bailey. Just those are your hashtags of the day. 844-500-4242. That is the toll free number of the Howie Carr Show. And I got to say, the other question I was thinking of doing as a poll question today, did you see the tweet that Elizabeth Warren sent out? I'll just read it to you. And remember, too, before we go any further, she's a gifted storyteller. That's what the New York Times said about her. She's a gifted storyteller. A young woman came up to me tonight and said, I'm a broke college student with a lot of student loan debt. I checked and I have $6 in the bank.
Wait a second, Howie. We can have Elizabeth Warren tell us this instead of you.
Oh, you have you have it? I just thought it was a tweet. I didn't know we had the actual sound. Okay, go ahead.
I tell you, there are so many people who are in this fight for all the right reasons. You know me, did the speech and then afterwards did a selfie line. And we were there for over an hour. People are coming through and they're saying thank you and they're giving hugs and talking about what's important to them. A young woman came up by herself and she said, I'm a broke college student with a lot of student loan debt. And she said, I checked and I have $6 in the bank. So I just gave $3 to keep you in this fight. That's what we got to do. We got to stay in this fight with people who are counting on us.
So she barely had enough money for a sandwich, right? Now she's got, as Chris Plant said, now she's got enough money for maybe a bag of potato chips and a soft drink. And this woman, we mentioned it yesterday, her mansion in Cambridge, which she bought with an interest-free loan from Harvard University because she was at that time the first woman of color at Harvard University on the faculty, is now worth $4 million, and she's taking $3 from the broke college student who now doesn't have enough money to buy herself a sandwich at Subway.
I also would like to know why this college student is broke, because in my experience, you don't start paying your school loans until you're 6 months out of college, not while you're still in college.
You know, Warren has plenty of wampum. She could have bought this woman a nice meal somewhere, you know, take her down to one of those diners where they were like everybody was looking away from her when she tried to come in and campaign before the primary yesterday. Good Lord. So that was my alternate poll question, Taylor. Do you believe that there is a college student who gave Elizabeth Warren $3 last night? I would say no.
Yeah, absolutely not.
There's no possible way. 844-500-4242. It was a big night for Bernie, though. And again, we're going to get to some calls, but we've just got so much sound. Every day now we have more sound than we can use, and I don't want to leave it all on the cutting room floor. Rashida Tlaib, you know who she is. She's one of the squad. I think she may be the dumbest one of the squad. I think she may be even dumber than AOC. And this is yet another reason why she's on some kind of finance committee in the House. And they had Jerome Powell as a witness yesterday. He was testifying, and he's the chairman of the Federal Reserve. And so she gets a question from the from her aides about what did the one of the previous chairmen of the Fed do, a guy by the name of Ben Bernanke, right? I mean, you know how to pronounce that name. You're not terribly familiar with him. I'm not terribly familiar with him, but
no. But during the housing crisis, this is the name you heard, right?
Right, right. I mean, we've heard it. Yeah, we've all heard it, the name a million times on various newscasts. We're just driving around or lying on the couch or read it in the paper. Rashida Tlaib has no idea how to pronounce Ben Bernanke's name. Listen, cut 33.
So I'm afraid that's simply not good enough. I mean, I think your predecessor's former chair is Yellen, and I believe it's Bernanke.
And then she goes on. I mean, she says it two or three times. Bernanke.
She said Bernanke.
Bernanke.
Yellen, and I believe it's Bernanke.
Bernanke. He's related to the Abenakis, the Indians that Elizabeth Warren was counting on to put her over the top yesterday in New Hampshire. But they all stayed home in their wigwams and their teepees and didn't come out. And meanwhile, last night, we'll take a quick call here. Harold, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Harold.
Yes, I'm retired NYPD. And if you ever listen to a radio scanner,
yeah,
the description that Mr. Bloomberg made of the 16 to 35,
yeah,
pretty much the Xerox thing. If you listen to a radio scanner in a black neighborhood, that's what you're going to hear all night. Male black, wearing this, wearing that, committed a crime, 10 minutes in the past,
right.
Boom.
Now, right.
The UF-50s, which is the stop, question, and frisk, I'm willing to bet it was done more by narcotics and anti-crime than regular uniform officers who are just walking around in uniform, not looking, omnipresence, trying to deter crime. So what he said, his numbers, what he said was factually good. Throwing people up against the wall was probably what anti-crime was doing, and narcotics, just throwing people randomly up against the wall looking for guns.
Yeah, but I mean, you should. Do you think that anybody, whether you're the police commissioner or the inspector or the mayor or anybody, should you really be talking about throwing people up against the wall?
Well, that wording was terrible, but the bottom line is the department is run by numbers.
Well, the other thing, Harold, is the other thing, though, Harold, is, he said 95% of the murders are committed by black males, basically. I mean, maybe in obviously in Bed-Stuy or, East New York, but I mean, nationwide, I mean, it's out of control, but it's only, I think, 55%. Right? By black males, 55. I mean, 95, 55. That's a big spread, isn't it?
That number wasn't accurate. It's about 55%. And
right.
13% of the population.
Right. So, are you black, by the way?
I happen to be black, sir. When I worked in a black neighborhood and I listened to my radio, all you hear all night long, male black this, male black. Why would you look for a white guy if the radio description says male black?
No, I understand. But what my question for you is, I mean, as someone who has experience with this and it's from New York City, I mean, are you a little put off, though, by what he said? I mean, everything, including the 95%, throw them up against the wall, et cetera, et cetera.
Yeah, that was uncalled for. That remark was uncalled for. But again, he's that's Mike Bloomberg. He's pompous.
Pompous. That's a good way to.
Pompous.
No, that's a good word. That's a perfect word. Yeah.
And what bothers me most about these people with this criminal justice nonsense and the bail reform, these people don't get released to their neighborhoods.
Yeah. Well, no, I mean,
these crimes are not committed in their neighborhoods.
But the thing is, I'll bet if you asked him now, he would be in favor of bail reform because he's trying to be woke and he's trying to make up for being for stop and frisk. And you're right, bail reform. I mean, we talk about it all the time. There's another horrible crime. It seems like every other day in New York because of this bail reform. Bail reform means there's no bail. Even if you kill some, if you're a drunk driver and you kill somebody, they will still let you out because you didn't mean to kill them. It's absurd. It's horrible. They've got to change that law. Thanks for the call, Harold. I appreciate it. 844-500-4242. I'm Howie Carr.
He's the maestro of microaggression. He's Howie Carr.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Best Western Adams Inn in Quincy. With beautiful views of Boston, waterfront restaurant, banquet facilities, and a great park and fly deal. Book direct by calling 617-328-1500. Mention Howie and save 10%.
Did you know that there is only one Sunday every year that Bank Chevrolet Buick GMC is open? Being closed on Sundays throughout the year is important to our team and their families. In February, everyone comes together for our fun President's Day weekend sale. It is so popular that we open on a Sunday to handle this once-a-year event. But you don't have to wait for President's Day weekend. Right now, Banks in Concord is offering President's Day pricing before February 17th. Visit BanksAutos.com and our full-service internet department can take care of most of the details before you even walk through the door. You'll find the lowest, most transparent pricing around, a friendly, no-pressure staff, and over 2,000 vehicles in stock. Right now, get President's Month savings on a new car, truck, or SUV. Great deals include a 2019 Silverado Double Cab for only $287 per month, or a 2020 Chevy Equinox LS for only $199 per month. Chevrolet, find new roads. Learn more about President's Month savings at BanksAutos.com. Bank Chevrolet, Buick GMC, and Concord, New Hampshire. Always a smart choice.
There are plenty of differences between Trump and the Democrats running for 2020, but the main one is Trump's pretty funny. Take a listen.
What advice would you give to the 25-year-old Donald Trump, knowing what you know today?
Don't run for president. I'm not a drinker. I can honestly say I never had a beer in my life, okay? It's one of my only good traits. I don't drink. Whenever they're looking for something good, I say, never had a glass of alcohol. I've never had alcohol. Can you imagine if I had? What a mess I'd be? I'd be the world's worst. Other countries, big countries, India and others, we had to pay because they considered them a growing country. They were a growing country. I said, what are we? Are we allowed to grow too? Okay. No, are we allowed to grow?
I try like hell to hide that bald spot, folks. I work harder. Doesn't look bad. Hey, we're hanging in.
I should have saved the Pocahontas thing for another year because I've destroyed her political career and now I won't get a chance to run against her and I would have loved it. I don't want to knock out all of the good stuff and end up with somebody that actually got talent. That would be terrible.
John, what happened at Perfect Smiles when you went?
The initial consultation was easy. In the past, they just hand me a clipboard, they fill out the forms, but that's not how I worked at Perfect Smiles. What was nice was it was a true consultation. They asked me my medical history or what I wanted to get out of the treatment plan. For me, I lived with TMJ. I'd literally have to crack my jaw throughout the day to relieve the pressure. I'd get headaches throughout the day, I'd be in pain. When I was at Perfect Smiles, they asked me what I wanted to get out of the treatment. You know, as a joke, I just said, geez, I'd love you to be able to fix my TMJ. And I was surprised because Dr. Houghton specializes in working with patients like me that have TMJ.
What were the results of visiting Dr. Houghton at Perfect Smiles?
Not only did I walk out of that office with a perfect smile, but he fixed my TMJ. It was a life-changing event. People tell me now that my smile's amazing. People would say, geez, John, your teeth look so great. I never realized my teeth looked so bad before. Now I take a look at the before and after pictures, and I'm amazed.
Go to Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire, or visit their website, perfectsmiles.com. And now, some of my favorite fake Indian cuts of all time. Oh, la, 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 la.
I'm not going to ask you for your favorite curse word. Actually, I am. Do you have a favorite curse word?
Poop.
Poop? That's a goody two-shoes favorite
not.
Curse word
no,
if I ever heard one.
Are you kidding? Have you ever seen a woman like me look you straight in the face after you finish some long explanation of something and then just said, poop?
Hold on a sec. I'm going to get me a beer.
I am not sure what she's talking about as far as a rally with.
It was a rally in Bern, Orchid, is that you have to figure out who you are. I grew up in a family that was barely hanging on to the ragged edge of the middle class. And my Aunt Bee has walked by that picture at least 1,000 times, remarked that her father, my papa, had high cheekbones like all of the Indians did.
This is Karen from Billerica, Massachusetts.
This is Adrian in Swanton, Vermont.
This is Miss Susan up in Warner, New Hampshire. And this is the Howie Carr Show.
The Republicans have
said they hoped you would learn a lesson from impeachment. What lesson did you learn from impeachment?
That the Democrats are crooked. They've got a lot of crooked things going. That they're vicious, that they shouldn't have brought impeachment,
anything
and that
yourself?
My poll numbers are 10 points higher because of fake news like NBC, which reports the news very inaccurately, probably more inaccurately than CNN, if that's possible.
I can't believe these angry Democrats wanted to stick Roger Stone in jail for 7 to 9 years for a couple of texts or tweets or forgetting, you know, whether he sent an email or a voicemail. I mean, they say, oh, this should be a sentence at the upper end of the sentencing guidelines. If you've ever been to a federal sentencing, they put you to sleep. They're saying, well, we have this recommendation, this report from the probation office about the sentencing guidelines, and under this you know, they've got all these categories, and it goes on, and you just want to get the sentence, and the judge gives him whatever he's going to give him, and the guy says the defendant says he's sorry, and he starts crying or whatever, and they just keep going on and on and on. There's no way that this guy deserved 7 to 9 years. He's not a violent threat. He has no criminal record. His crime, I said it yesterday, he's found guilty of being a Republican. That's what it is. Why don't we just have separate sentencing guidelines for Republicans? That's what these people would like, these angry Democrats, these guys that tried to put him away. I'm glad they're gone. It's a self-draining swamp, as somebody said. 844-500-4242. Tim, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Tim.
Hey, Howie. I love your show.
Thank you.
I think in talking to my older parents who watch MSNBC religiously, the huge problem is that people on that side don't have a clue about what's really happening because their news is so filtered and so handpicked.
Right.
They need something solid, like someone to go away to jail that they have to report. So Trump made a big mistake by deciding not to go after Hillary because he could have nailed her. She would have went away.
I don't know. He would have. Well, we'll talk more about it. I get some sound cuts from MSNBC and from New Hampshire. I'm Howie Carr. John, what happened at Perfect Smiles when you went?
The initial consultation was easy. In the past, they just hand me a clipboard to fill out the forms, but that's not how I worked at Perfect Smiles. What was nice was it was a true consultation. They asked me my medical history or what I wanted to get out of the treatment plan. For me, I lived with TMJ. I'd literally have to crack my jaw throughout the day to relieve the pressure. I'd get headaches throughout the day. I'd be in pain. When I was at Perfect Smiles, they asked me what I wanted to get out of the treatment. You know, as a joke, I just said, geez, I'd love you to be able to fix my TMJ. And I was surprised because Dr. Houghton specializes in working with patients like me that have TMJ.
What were the results of visiting Dr. Houghton at Perfect Smiles?
Not only did I walk out of that office with a perfect smile, but he fixed my TMJ. It was a life-changing event. People tell me now that my smile's amazing. People would say, geez, John, your teeth look so great. I never realized my teeth looked so bad before. Now I take a look at the before and after pictures, and I'm amazed.
Go to Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire, or visit their website, perfectsmiles.com.
And now, 1 minute of Nancy Pelosi.
It is a bill that is much needed for our farmers and ranchers. I think there are only 47 votes against it in the House of Representatives. The American people should know the source of it. Again, we are engaged in the year-end continuing resolution, Homeland Security. I'm not sure.
No, I haven't spoken to him since he called the other day, which was a very amicable conversation. Amiable, I guess you would say, not amicable.
And I talked to Chuck last night to say, you know, we haven't had an answer. There are other things that are going on that are newsworthy. And I think I think you'd have more viewers or readers if it would address concerns that people have. The list goes on about the
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Who was your favorite actor?
Humphrey Bogart, no doubt about it. I love all the old Humphrey Bogart movies. Jimmy Cagney would be a close second.
Do you have a celebrity crush?
No celebrity crushes.
Ginger or Marianne?
I always was a Marianne person. Never was bowled over by that Hollywood look. Plus, Ginger was in more revealing attire, scantily clad.
Salty or sweet?
Neither, but if I have to pick, I'll go with sweet.
Movies or TV?
TV.
McDonald's or Burger King?
McDonald's, although I'd prefer Five Guys.
Facebook or Twitter?
Definitely Twitter. I hate Facebook.
Cake or pie?
I'm a cake guy.
Coke or Pepsi?
Diet Coke.
Coffee or tea?
Coffee, obviously.
Winter or summer?
Summer. Good Lord. Why would you want winter? It's cold and it's dark.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. You get a lot of patients, I'm sure, who are apprehensive about veneers. What are some of the questions and fears you get when you're dealing with new patients?
Some people think they could look too fake, but true cosmetic dentistry is incredibly detail-oriented. So we put a lot of time and effort into individualizing how the smile looks, and we really make them look natural, but very, very pleasant.
You know, people are concerned. They wonder, you know, I got my teeth. Do I really want to put caps on?
Exactly. Yeah, they think they'll have that Hollywood look or fake look, but the technology that we have available and the artistry that we can create now really makes things so natural that most people, in fact, most dentists are just surprised that we can create what we can create nowadays. Everyone is different. Everyone has different facial dimensions, different bone structure, and we do everything we can to individualize treatment because there is no one perfect smile. It is your perfect smile.
Dr. Houghton, where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE, 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE.
Brace yourself, guys. Here is 1 minute of Nancy Pelosi.
I myself have always been for lowering the voting age to 16. I think it's really important to capture kids when they're in high school, which was a very amicable conversation. Amiable, I guess you would say, not amicable.
That they wanted their voices to be heard.
I don't think our colleague is anti-Semitic. I think she has a different experience in the use of words.
That's not the total package, but that are, there are some of the major points of discussion, I would hope, from sea to shining sea, because they are not getting paid Republicans voted no. Wisdom from the kitchen of the Willard Hotel, yes, ma'am.
The president either doesn't know what he's talking about or doesn't want to know what he's talking about.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
If you could go back in time and give your younger self advice, what would you say?
Get a state job, because behind the job comes the pension.
What's the best advice anyone's ever given you?
Most advice is pretty forgettable.
What's the best money you've ever spent?
The investment I made to leave the corporate radio prison I was in. The worst people I ever worked for, no doubt about it. I'd probably be dead if I were still working for them.
If you were on a deserted island and you could only bring three things, what would you bring?
A radio, a Wi-Fi system, obviously, and a computer. And I would bring some books. Don't ask me which books. Too hard a question.
What was your dad's job when you were growing up?
My dad worked as a resort hotel manager. He worked in Florida at the Breakers in the winter, and then he worked at the Mountain View House, as it was called then, in Whitefield, New Hampshire, and various other places.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
Cory Booker said it best.
There are definitely moments where you listen to Joe Biden and you just wonder.
Here's stumbling and mumbling Bo Judd, Joe Biden.
David Duke, the former leader of the KKK.
The Ku Klux Klan is the Ku Klux Klan.
8 more years of Donald Trump will change America in a fundamental way. And if Donald Trump is reelected, Freudian slip, and the demagogues around the world.
We also have a mechanism to control drug prices. Folks at the folks at Health and the Health Department in the United States, HHS.
They would put 720 million million women back in the workforce.
I never ever thought that I'd see what I saw in Charlotte.
Would you or would you not rejoin the TPP? Yes or no?
I would not rejoin the TTP.
Well, they're going out and getting G5 and going to dominate. I mean, what are we doing?
Bills that the president, the future president here, that the senator is talking about.
Subaru of New England, Washington's birthday sales event lasts all month long. Feel the freedom in the all-new all-wheel drive 2020 Subaru Outback with standard LED headlights. Starting at only $26,645 with 0.9% financing for up to 48 months. Or lease for only $249 per month for 36 months with $2,449 due at signing. Details at SubaruofNewEngland.com.
The Moonbats always say Donald Trump isn't very bright. But what about Barack Hussein Obama? Let's listen to some of his greatest hits.
I've now been in 57 states. I think one left to go. I don't know what the term is in Austrian.
The Cambridge police acted stupidly.
And there has never been any man or woman more qualified for this office than Hillary Clinton.
There are neighborhoods around the country where it is easier for a 12 or 13 year old to purchase a gun and cheaper than it is for them to get a book.
I believe in the Second Amendment. It's there written on the paper.
If we fall for, you know, a bunch of okey-doke.
A few months ago, when you were asked what's the biggest geopolitical threat facing America, you said Russia, not Al-Qaeda. You said Russia in the 1980s or now. Calling to ask for their foreign policy back.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you today in part by Rejuven Ice Cryo in Peabody. Bring down inflammation and increase energy at Rejuven Ice Cryo.
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
I plan on trying to win New Hampshire. I'm not here to come in second.
Both Elizabeth Warren and Joe Biden will not meet that 15% threshold. And as a result, they will be shut out of pledged delegates in the state of New Hampshire tonight.
We're going to be back in New Hampshire. We're going to be back there to defeat Donald Trump in November.
Nobody under 10% at this point in the process has ever went on to win the nomination and has ever really been, you know, competitive at the end.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
So something has happened in the last 48 hours. People have told me that they're giving Amy Klobuchar a second look.
I wonder why.
I am not going to sugarcoat it. We took a gut punch in Iowa.
You're a lying dog-faced pony soldier.
You cannot have 20, 30, 40, 50 clips in a weapon.
Are you concerned about the message that you're sending to New Hampshire by going to South Carolina?
Not at all.
And why are you so negative?
I'm not getting up on New Hampshire. No poke out in my face, okay, buddy?
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
You know, we're counting on having the wind of New Hampshire at our backs. I've got a reservation to fly on to South Carolina tomorrow afternoon.
I am so sorry. That flight is canceled.
Former Massachusetts Governor Deval Patrick is expected to suspend his campaign.
And Diane and I are going to go home and rest and reflect on this outcome.
We're going to be fine.
You know, I am the math guy. And it is clear tonight from the numbers that we are not going to win this race. I am suspending my campaign for president.
Unchained and unstoppable.
President Trump last night had the highest voter turnout of any incumbent in four decades. He also had the highest percent of the vote of any incumbent in the past four decades. The enthusiasm's on President Trump's side. Democrats, by the way, have a dumpster fire.
Trump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
Wasn't it a fun night on TV last night, watching those Democrat candidates falling down like dominoes or bowling pins? You know, Andrew Yang out of the race, Michael Bennett out of the race. Who? Michael Bennett? I thought he played for the Cowboys. Then he was with the Seahawks and then the Cowboys, and now he's dropped. He's lost one of his T's and he's dropped out of the race. And then there was a report, some fake news that Tom Steyer was out of the race, but that turned out to be untrue. And then Deval Patrick, the former governor, Deval Patrick out of the race, the former Massachusetts governor after a wretched performance. Apparently he said that his there's a, stories that saying that his campaign, I didn't know he had a campaign. I just thought he had a cell phone, but he's going to be fine. His campaign said he couldn't get noticed, to which I, you know what he should have invested in one of those boxes like Michael Bloomberg uses, or Trump says Michael Bloomberg uses. He's about the same size as Michael Bloomberg.
Hey, Howie.
I'm in charge.
Yes.
Liz Warren actually sent out an email to her supporters last night.
Yes.
And one of her supporters posted it online, and I was wondering if I could do a little reading here.
Now, is this real, or is this like her experience with the college student who gave her half of her worldly possessions?
Oh, no.
$3. Did this really happen? Is what I'm asking.
This really happened. This is what she sent out after the results.
Okay.
And feel free to chime in, but I'm going to read the whole thing. Okay. So here we go. Let's face it, Courtney. Last night didn't go the way we wanted it to go.
Speak for yourself, fake Indian.
We were hoping for a better result in New Hampshire. And a lot of volunteers and grassroots supporters fought really hard to make it happen.
And now I'm on the war path. I know I finished far down the totem pole, and I'm running out of wampum, but I'm not going home to my $4 million teepee in Harvard Square.
It hurts to care so much, work so hard, and still fall a little short. So it's okay to take a moment and feel that pain.
And have a cold beer, a cold Michelob Ultra Light.
Take a walk around the block.
With Bailey.
Eat an extra piece of chocolate.
How about cheese? Can we go down to the cheese shop, fake Indian?
Hug your pet.
Bailey!
Adopt a pet. Watch videos of cats and dogs who are friends. Call a friend. Whatever works. But once you've let it all out.
What a phony.
Take a deep breath. Square your shoulders and make a plan. A plan to fight back and win.
When can I let my breath out, fake Indian?
A plan to help make sure that we don't have to feel this way again.
I felt pretty damn good last night, Grace, didn't you?
I did. I felt fine. But, you know, I'm not Courtney. Whoever Courtney is out there, let's face it, Courtney.
Maybe Courtney's the college student that gave her the $3.
Could be. You know, I should tell Courtney that $3, how you said a bag of chips, but I told you I went to McDonald's the other day. I got a hot fudge sundae. I got a small fry and a small Coke for $5. $2 more. She could have had herself a real, I'm just saying.
But she doesn't have $5 anymore. She gave $3 to Elizabeth Warren.
Here's what I'm saying, Howie. If you are in debt, student debt, any kind of debt, you gotta prioritize. Okay. And you know what's number one priority? Food, nourishment. Elizabeth Warren's campaign, I would say that's 1,024th on the list.
You get that? You get that, folks? 1,124th. That's what percentage of American Indian blood she may have. And incidentally, some people are saying, okay, you guys like Elizabeth Warren being humiliated, but what about those of us who like Uncle Joe being humiliated?
I have that. Don't worry. We have plenty of Joe Biden.
Let's play the thing where, you know, I've been saying recently that the Joe Biden life now reminds me of a famous novel from the 60s, Slaughterhouse-Five by Kurt Vonnegut. And it's about this guy named Billy Pilgrim. And there's a famous line in the novel by Kurt Vonnegut. Billy Pilgrim has come unstuck in time. And as I've been saying for months now, Joe Biden has come unstuck in time, like Billy Pilgrim. So yesterday, Grace, he became unstuck in time again. He began confusing the order of the primaries and the caucuses. Cut 9.
The people of Nevada are watching, and I want to make it clear we praise their diversity as a state, and I'm going to be out there seeing them very soon. Tonight, though, we just heard from the first two of 50 states. It's important that Iowa and Nevada have spoken, but look, we need to hear from Nevada and South Carolina and Super Tuesday states and beyond.
Iowa and Nevada have spoken, and now it's time we hear from Nevada.
Nevada, the good...
two primary states.
You know, and there's North Nevada and there's South Nevada, like South Carolina. Am I in South Carolina or am I in North Dakota?
You know what, though, Howie? I'm going to help Joe Biden out because I know he's got a lot in his plate. He's trying to figure out what state he's in at all times and mental state and also actual state. I want to help him out because this Friday is Valentine's Day. And you know what, Uncle Joe? You got a lot to worry about. You don't got to worry about Valentine's Day. It's just 2 days away. Uncle Joe, you need to act fast with 1-800-Flowers.com. Today, you can get the 24-stem colorful rose medley for only $29.99 or upgrade to 24 red roses for only $10 more. Howie's got them on his desk. I am not happy that I am not there for multiple reasons. One of them being I would have stolen those flowers.
It's 85 degrees today, Grace. 85.
The flowers were enough for me to be jealous, Howie. I don't need another weather. To order, go to 1-800-Flowers.com and enter code Howie.
Look at how beautiful they are, Grace.
They're stunning.
By the way, they came in today.
Where did the flowers go that were in the Boston studio here?
You know what? I got word that they needed to be taken away.
They were just taken away.
Yeah, I had to do it.
The mailroom manager had allowed me to take those flowers home to my wife.
Oh, well, the mailroom manager was...
Don't be so cheap. Don't be so cheap, Taylor. Why shouldn't I be?
Taylor, only $29.99. You can upgrade to 24 red roses.
What's the phone number for Taylor to call?
Well, he can go to 1-800-Flowers.com and Howie, okay. Or I'm assuming call 1-800-Flowers.
Okay, 1-800-Flowers.com.
Howie... Do I have time to read you a few quotes from this New York Post article about Joe Biden? I think you're really going to like them. It's called Why Joe Biden's Campaign is Collapsing.
Yes.
Okay. Biden's New Hampshire, and I'm just skipping around here.
No, I've got the story in front of me, too. Go ahead.
Biden's New Hampshire effort is just sad. Last week, he had to skip a full day of campaigning in New Hampshire to reassure donors and reorder his campaign staff. On Tuesday, he announced he would stick around in the Granite State to celebrate. He wouldn't stick around to celebrate the results. He is low on money, and the crush of ad spending by Michael Bloomberg and Tom Steyer in critical states means that he can barely afford to compete in key markets. His events seem exhausted and strained, his voice quavering between a harsh staccato and a whisper. Democrat nomination battles tend to favor the new and inspiring instead of the old and tested. Then the guy goes on to talk about, this is my favorite part. Some writers compare Biden's stream of unconsciousness, because he called that voter a lying dog faced pony soldier, reminiscent of good times and bad to onion belt stories, a reference to old grandpa Abe Simpson's meandering, pointless stories featuring the immortal line, quote, "So I tied an onion to my belt," which was the style at the time, end quote. And the article goes on to say,
you could look it up on your phonograph record.
The article goes on to say that he can't compete with Bernie Sanders because he doesn't have socialism, which is such a new thing, right. And he's not woke enough, and so he's just like you said, he's in between everyone, and it's just collapsing. And I'm going to tweet this article out.
Heads like we used to, but we have our ways.
Oh, you got it.
One trick is to tell them stories that don't go anywhere, like the time I caught the ferry over to Shelbyville. I needed a new heel for my shoe, so I decided to go to Morganville, which is what they call Shelbyville in those days.
It's so true. I mean, I could just see myself, if I ran into Joe Biden at an event or something and he started talking crazy, I would just say, oh, I'm so sorry. I have to go to the bathroom. I'll be right back. And I'd make sure he was in a safe spot with someone that could like watch over him. And then I'd make my way to the exit. I couldn't deal with that. He talks nonsense.
Now that most dog tracks have shut down, Grace.
Yes.
Where do you take people like Joe Biden?
So my dad asked me the other day, Howie, he said, you should have Howie do a poll question. Who regrets not retiring to the dog tracks more? Joe Biden or Weld?
Is Joe Biden going to go to the farm with Bailey?
Seriously.
He is ready for the farm.
And speaking of dogs, Howie, on the other side, I have tons of dog stories, not just Siba, who's our poll question, but also a pit bull story and a Pamela Anderson story.
Oh, is this her latest marriage?
Yes. The guy, Howie, who she married, he used a quote that you love, and I'm going to read it on the other side.
No, I know. I saw that in the New York Post today. I was thinking of my Aunt Mabel when I saw that quote. Yeah, John Peters, Barbara Streisand's ex, her ex hairdresser, and other. He's performed other services as well. All right, 844-500-4242. Look at these beautiful roses. I'm Howie Carr.
Keep it here, chumps. More Howie Carr after this.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by ButcherBox. Taste the amazing difference of ButcherBox by signing up at ButcherBox.com/Howie and get two filet mignons, one pack of bacon, and $20 off your first box. ButcherBox.com/Howie.
Are you looking for a pre-owned car? Well, before you go to the dealership where you'll be pounced on by pushy salespeople, give the car guys a try. I'm Bill Papa George, and my job is to make finding the perfect used car as easy as possible. That means I do all of the tough legwork for you.
Howie, once I figure out, I think out we what need some authentic car, frontier gibberish.
I've been in this business for a long time, and I know what to look out for. I won't bring you a car unless I know it will meet or exceed your expectations. So give me a call at 800-300-4600. That is 800-300-4600.
Hey, business owners and marketing professionals, would you like to advertise on the Howie Carr Radio Network? Howie's show reaches all across New England. And you know who's listening? Your next customer, client, or business lead. If you're interested in advertising on the Howie Carr Show, call 800-227-7300. That's 800-227-7300. You're listening to Howie, and so is your next customer. Call 800-227-7300 right now.
And now, another minute of Madam Speaker, Nancy Pelosi.
But again, don't
you have these wings, AOC and her group on one side.
It's like five people. They would say, play games, and then they'd say, open sesame. Except we don't say sesame, we say open Biden. But no, I because we are not. We have the number is growing. We have 91 women. There are 115 women in Congress, 116. 15 are Republican, 91 are Democrats. I happen to be a manifestation of the women power that is coming forth now, but only one manifestation. It was like getting kicked in the back by a mule constantly. It was physical. It was so unbelievable. The Times found Lincoln. Not to be presumptuous to put ourselves in those categories, but the Times have found us.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
There are plenty of differences between Trump and the Democrats running for 2020, but the main one is Trump's pretty funny. Take a listen.
What advice would you give to the 25-year-old Donald Trump, knowing what you know today?
Don't run for president. I'm not a drinker. I can honestly say I never had a beer in my life, okay? It's one of my only good traits. I don't drink. Whenever they're looking for something good, I say, I never had a glass of alcohol. I've never had alcohol. Can you imagine if I had? What a mess I'd be? I'd be the world's worst. Other countries, big countries, India and others, we had to pay because they considered them a growing country. They were a growing country. I said, what are we? Are we allowed to grow too? Okay. So are we allowed to grow?
I try like hell to hide that bald spot, folks. I work harder. Doesn't look bad. Hey, we're hanging in.
I should have saved the Pocahontas thing for another year because I've destroyed her political career and now I won't get a chance to run against her. And I would have loved it. I don't want to knock out all of the good stuff and end up with somebody that's actually got talent. That would be terrible.
Uh,
Hi, this is John in the People's Republic of Amherst, Massachusetts.
This is Heather from Litchfield, Maine.
This is Kemp, Wichita, Kansas, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
Now, where were we? Oh, yeah. The important thing was that I had an onion on my belt, which was a style at the time. They didn't have white onions because of the war. The only thing you could get was those big yellow ones.
That was Joe Biden just a couple hours ago in Spartanburg, South Carolina. He's in the Palmetto State now. That was Grandpa Abe Simpson. 844-500-4242. 917 texter says, how can Warren be doing so poorly? She's taking so many selfies. What are all these people that she's taking selfies with? What are they going to do once she's out of the race? They're going to have to start taking pictures of their entrees and their desserts at the Cheesecake Factory in and Olive Garden, you know? Yeah, that's a yard signs don't translate into votes and neither do selfies.
I took a lot of selfies at the Trump rally, and I don't think I'm going to be elected president.
You didn't do too well last night in the vote totals. You almost tied the Val Patrick, Grace.
Hey, Howie, speaking of the votes last night, is there a candidate with the last name Gooner?
Was there? I don't know.
Someone kept tagging me saying Gooner's in fourth place. I think there is. I might be wrong. That might be fake news, but I thought there was.
So in other words, Gooner did better than Bailey.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Howie, so we got to do the poll question about SEBA, and then I want to talk about Pam Anderson.
Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company that I trust. Give them a call today to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling now. Call them today at 800-912-2300, and with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Which dog would you have voted for to win the Westminster Dog Show?
It's very controversial, by the way. The crowd was for the Golden Retriever, but the judges were for the poodle. Go ahead.
SEBA, the Standard Poodle, or Daniel, the Golden Retriever?
I'm voting for SEBA, the Standard Poodle, in memory of my Standard Poodle, Princess.
I will vote for the Golden Retriever because he looked like a very good boy.
90% wanted the Golden Retriever.
Oh, Golden Retrievers, Howie, they're crowd pleasers.
And Elizabeth Warren is going, where were they yesterday in New Hampshire?
Exactly.
Didn't I bring Bailey up enough times for them to pet him and to have their selfies taken with him?
Why didn't she go to the polls with Bailey? I didn't see Bailey around.
No, she made a lot of mistakes.
It's not that far of a drive for Bailey.
No, it isn't. No, not at all.
So I have really sad news. Pamela Anderson's marriage to John Peters only lasted 12 days.
I thought this was one for the ages. Especially, it's really a sad thing right here at Valentine's Day.
Well, that's the thing, Howie. Is that as someone who's getting married, I really thought this one was built to last, and it only lasted 12 days. So I want to tell John Peters, don't give up. If you want to send Pamela some flowers, you need to act fast with 1-800-flowers.com. You can get 24 colorful rose medley for only $29.99 or upgrade to 24 roses, which you probably should because this thing's on the brink, for only $10 more. Go to 1-800-flowers.com and enter code Howie. You just have 2 days, John. But this is the part of the story that Howie's going to like. John Peters claims that after he paid off some of Pam Anderson's debts, the broke actress dumped him. Left him in the dirt. And then he said, quote, there's no fool like an old fool, end quote.
Somewhere my Aunt Mabel is smiling. She always used to say that to me.
I mean, he paid off her debts. You know, this is what Elizabeth Warren should be telling those college students. Don't donate to my campaign. Find yourself a John Peters. Let him pay off some of these debts.
Well, you know, this is the way it works, Grace. You know, John Peters found Barbara Streisand and she paid off all of his debts. And then now he's got plenty of money. And so he gets taken.
It's like Palm Beach.
Exactly. That's what I was going to say. It's the Palm Beach way. Gold Digger takes out former gigolo. Then Gold Digger, the gigolo dies and the Gold Digger is taken advantage of by the young gigolo. It's generations.
It's the circle of life.
Exactly. The circle of life on Palm Beach Island. 844-500-4242. We'll be right back with a author of an interesting new book. I'm Howie Carr. Something I look forward to every month is my shipment from ButcherBox. ButcherBox delivers 100% grass-fed and grass-finished beef, organic, free-range chicken, heritage breed pork, and wild-caught Alaskan salmon directly to your door with free shipping. ButcherBox is the most convenient way to get meat the way it's meant to be, natural, fresh, and delicious. Choose from four curated boxes or customize your own box with all of your favorite cuts. And if you want to try something new, ButcherBox has a ton of awesome recipes and resources on their website that'll help you bring out the flavor of each cut of meat you get from ButcherBox. And to make things even better, ButcherBox is offering new members two filet mignons, one pack of bacon, and $20 off your first box when you sign up at butcherbox.com/Howie. That's butcherbox.com/Howie for $20 off your first box, plus two filet mignons and a free pack of bacon. butcherbox.com/Howie. Enough with the fake news. You need to listen to Honest Howie's History. In my new weekly podcast, I take you behind the scenes of the most talked about news events and compare them to the past. We're going to go back 100 years here, but let's start with the latest politician in the Kennedy family's crosshairs. Whatever happened to the Massachusetts State Police? You know, Hermann Goering, the Nazi. Nobody thought that there was any conspiracy there. Of course he was going to kill himself. Honest Howie's History. Listen today at HowieCarrShow.com. I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. Dr. Houghton, tell us about the state-of-the-art procedures that can help many people look 10 to 15 years younger.
As we age, we do lose these proper proportions to our faces. And so if you're deficient in your chin or mid-face, we can create the proper proportions and make you look great. Sometimes we use orthodontics to change the look of the face. Sometimes we just use the teeth themselves and it creates the right support for a beautiful face. They're all non-surgical procedures.
There's some pretty complex cases that you deal with. Give me an example of a tough case.
Well, some cases, people just are missing a lot of teeth. I get a lot of people that come in and think that I cannot solve their problems because they're too great, but I really can. We've been doing this for over 35 years and there isn't much that we haven't seen.
So even if you're missing a few teeth or your teeth are discolored or you're very embarrassed, there's no reason not to come in for a consultation, right?
Absolutely. New techniques, new technology, things are available to us that we never had before and we can handle just about everything.
Where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE.
And now, a minute of wisdom from Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez.
Millennials and people and, you know, Gen Z and all these folks that come after us are looking up and we're like, the world is going to end in 12 years if we don't address climate change. And your biggest issue is, your biggest issue is how are we going to pay for it? And like, this is the war. This is our World War II.
I think that there's a lot of people more concerned about being precisely, factually, and semantically correct than about being morally right.
But being factually correct is important.
It's absolutely important.
And if we work our butts off to make sure that we take back all three chambers of Congress, all three chambers of government, the presidency, the Senate, and the House in 2020, we can't start working in 2020.
He's the co-sponsor of the Green New Deal, so what better time to play some of his greatest hits? Ladies and gentlemen, it's Mr. Frosty.
This is going to be a mission to save all of creation.
If you want to ignore that these changes are taking place and that they're having a dramatic impact, then you are in the right place.
You know what the winters were like at Plymouth Rock? You know what the winters were like at Plymouth Rock, Senator?
Well, here is the thing.
You don't. How long has your family been in Massachusetts?
We are new arrivals. And
Mr. President, American history was made last night. The Boston Patriots won the Super Bowl.
When the Second Amendment was written in order to maintain a well-regulated militia, they did not have in mind that people could purchase guns indiscriminately. The president is acting like Pontius Pilate.
Hold on, Howie. We're coming back early.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
Go ahead.
844-500-4242. Every day when I drive to work here in Florida, sunny South Florida, as Rush calls it, I go by all this construction in West Palm Beach. There's just all kinds of new condo developments going up. And we come all the way down to Boca, and we turn right to come to the Newsmax studios, and there's a giant new apartment complex going up. And I just I always wonder, you know, who's going to be living in these new developments that are going up. And I know where, I don't know who's going to be living there, but I know where they're coming from. They're coming from New York. They're coming from Massachusetts. They're coming from Illinois, places like that. Big high tax blue states. They're coming down to this wonderful red state of Florida with no income taxes. And a great Republican governor, DeSantis, two great Republican senators, Rubio and Scott, and a lot of great Republican congressmen. And you know, I just wonder what's going to happen. I'm concerned. I'm concerned. People in New Hampshire are concerned. So joining us now on the line is Kristen Tate, and she's the author of a new book about what's happening here with the migration of people from the failing blue states of the North and the Midwest and the West too, to the red states of the Sun Belt. Kristen Tate, the title of her book is The Liberal Invasion of Red State America. Kristen, thanks for being with us here on the Howie Carr Show.
Howie, it's an honor to be with you. My whole family is all big fans of you. They all listen to you on WNTK up in New Hampshire. So really excited to be on the show.
Well, New Hampshire has changed a lot since Meldrum Thompson was the governor and William Loeb was the publisher, the Manchester Union Leader. I mean, New Hampshire is a classic state that has gone from being a red state to being a purple trending blue state. I mean, that's, you know, it's not just people aren't just fleeing south. They're fleeing wherever the taxes are low, correct?
That's exactly right. So I grew up in New Hampshire in a little town called Grantham. And 20 years ago, it was all Republicans up there. Grantham had one of the lowest property tax rates in the entire state. But over the last decade, this huge influx of Massachusetts expats moved up there and basically completely transformed the political landscape of my hometown. You know, it used to be a little town full of pickup trucks and Republicans. Now it's all full of Priuses, hybrid vehicles, and these liberals who come in there, they go to the town hall meetings in Grantham and they demand more money for the school systems and all these new programs. So that's why I wanted to write this book, because Howie, this trend's going on across the country. Domestic migration from blue states to red states is going to completely reshape the political map. It's already happening. I mean, New York and California are each going to be losing congressional seats, while Texas and Florida will gain seats.
Right.
The Republicans have got to wake up to this, because it's posed challenges for them in elections.
Well, sometimes I fill in for Mark Simone on WOR in New York City, and it seems like half of my listeners and callers are former New Yorkers who are now living in Florida or, you know, other Tennessee or any low tax state. And they still listen on the stream, but they've got out. I mean, yeah, it seems like half of New York is down in Florida now. And it's, you know, the thing is though, Kristen, you know, you say it's sort of under the radar. I think people notice it big time. I mean, don't you think everybody in your hometown in New Hampshire knows what's going on? You there, Kristen?
It's been happening incrementally, Howie, and a lot of times people don't wake up to what's going on until it's way too late. And, you know, on one hand, these trends are vindicating for Republicans because people are flocking to the places with conservative fiscal policy. But on the other hand, it's just totally changing the political landscape of these places. I mean, like Texas is gaining a record number of California expats. If we lose Texas, Howie, it's all over.
I understand.
A Republican will never become president again. So these liberal pinheads, they just move to greener pastures and then they vote in favor of the policies they fled. It's so frustrating.
Yeah, you know, we're talking to Kristen Tate. She's the author of The Liberal Invasion of Red State America, was just published by Regnery last month. What I don't understand is, you know, if you're fleeing California, LA, or San Francisco because you can't take the homeless on the street, the feces everywhere, the needles, the incredible influx of illegal aliens, why would you move to Texas and then want to recreate the same conditions that drove you out of what used to be called the Golden State? Same with New Hampshire. You know, you're fleeing Taxachusetts. Why do you want to set up a system that's going to require a sales tax, an income tax? That's what makes New Hampshire great, that it doesn't have a sales tax or an income tax.
You're exactly right. The sad thing is a lot of people just move to the states where there are more good paying jobs available. That happens to be red states. So they move for jobs and then they just keep on voting for Democrats without thinking about why the jobs are in the red states in the first place. So Howie, for all your listeners out there who live in red states, Florida, New Hampshire, Texas, wherever they are, we have got to reach out to our new neighbors from blue states and make them understand why these conservative states have flourished. We've got to reach out and build bridges.
Well, don't, again, Crystal, I come back to, don't they understand why they're not in New York or Illinois or Massachusetts or Michigan anymore? Don't they understand why they are now living in Tennessee or Texas or Florida? I mean, come on.
It's so frustrating. You know, I'm a millennial, Howie, and a lot of my friends do not even realize that California used to be a Republican stronghold. The demographics of Texas today are almost identical to those of California in the late 80s, right before, Democrats started their winning streak of presidential wins in California. So I live in Texas now, and you can see the cities in particular are becoming more and more populist and more liberal as these California people move in for our jobs. So, you know, on one hand, it's vindicating. It's a great trend because it shows Republican policy works. But these people come in and they vote in favor of the same exact policies they fled without even realizing it.
You call Colorado East California. Why is that?
Well, because all of these people are leaving California because of the high costs and the slow corporate growth. They go to Colorado, which is a more low-cost state with a lot of job growth. And then they proceed to vote in favor of, you know, these laws that essentially aim to kill the gas and oil industry out in California, which has been, you know, a driving force behind their economic boom. And they're basically just recreating another California out there in Colorado, which is sad because Colorado for years has been one of the nation's great independent purple states, but it's really becoming blue because of all of these Californians moving there.
I think in the 2020 election, we should be okay because, like in Colorado, for instance, they have a giant fracking industry, and whoever's the Democratic nominee is going to be on the record as wanting to shut down the fracking industry, put hundreds of thousands of Coloradans out of business. I think, the economic boom is going to mean a lot more minority voters for Donald Trump. But I think long term, you're right. I mean, this is very worrisome trend. I don't know what the answer is.
Yeah. Well, here's the thing. Even before Texas turns blue or Colorado turns completely blue, as they're transforming, Republicans are going to have to spend more time and resources campaigning there, which takes away time and resources from other states. But here's what makes me hopeful, Howie. Donald Trump has done more to expand the Republican tent than any other Republican in modern political history. So even though these demographic changes are pretty troubling, Trump is bringing more people into the tent from around the country. I mean, these union workers, blue collar workers, former blue dog Democrats. So that's mitigating this domestic migration trend, at least a little bit.
Yeah. I got a text here. I live next to Grantham, New Hampshire, and the ex-Massachusetts new neighbors came around wanting me to sign a petition to pave our dirt road. I chased them off. How about it? I'll tell you another thing they're doing in New Hampshire, just because I've heard from people who live in New Hampshire. They're trying to change the laws. All the rod and gun clubs are grandfathered in when the areas go more suburban, so that you can still keep, you know, the old style, rod and gun clubs can still stay in business. But they want to change all the people from Massachusetts moving into New Hampshire, and I'm sure this is going on in other states. They want to change the laws to put all these gun clubs out of business. I mean, why do they come and they think they have the right to change the way people have lived in New Hampshire or Florida or Texas for 200 years?
As you know, Howie, liberalism is a religion. These people just, they ruin everywhere they go. In New Hampshire specifically, they're all moving to the southern part of the state.
Right.
But the top part of New Hampshire is still very red, very libertarian. And the folks up there, they are very worried by what's going on. I mean, we have all Democrats that control the state now, other than Governor Sununu.
Yeah, I know. He says he's the last man standing. My father used to work in Whitefield.
Thank God for him.
I used to spend a lot of time in Whitefield when I was a kid. I drove through there a couple of years ago, and it hasn't changed all that much. Unlike, like you say, the southern tier of New Hampshire is just it's Massachusetts North. And it's really unfortunate because all these people, they all voted with their feet. They're economic refugees. And then they create the same havoc in the society that they tried to flee in the blue state of Massachusetts. It's a very interesting book, Kristen Tate. And I look forward to taking a closer look at it. It's called The Liberal Invasion of Red State America. And it's available. You can get it on Amazon, The Liberal Invasion of Red State America by Kristen Tate. Thanks for being with us. And thanks to you and your family for listening to the show on WNTK. I appreciate it.
Thank you very much, Howie. It's an honor.
Thank you. Every night, local police departments across America receive hundreds of calls from burglar alarms. The vast majority of the time, they have no idea whether the alarm is real. Is there really a crime going on or not? All the alarm company could tell them is the motion sensor went off. SimpliSafe Home Security is different. If there's a break-in, SimpliSafe uses real video evidence to give police an eyewitness account of the crime. That means police dispatch up to 350% faster than for a normal burglar alarm. You get comprehensive protection for your entire home. Outdoor cameras and doorbells alert you to anyone approaching your home. Entry, motion, and glass break sensors guard inside. Plus, SimpliSafe protects your home from fires, water damage, and carbon monoxide poisoning. It's 24/7 monitoring by live security professionals. You can set up the system yourself. No tools needed, or SimpliSafe can do it for you. And it's only 50 cents a day with no contracts. Visit SimpliSafeHowie.com. You'll get free shipping at a 60-day risk-free trial. Go now and be sure you go to SimpliSafeHowie.com so they know that our show sent you. That's SimpliSafeHowie.com. I'm Howie Carr.
He's the guru of graft. It's Howie Carr.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate. Howie Carr.
Would you say you're more like your mom or your dad?
No, I don't think I ended up being like either of them now that I think about it. My mother worked hard, but she never really learned how to make a lot of money. And my father didn't work so hard, but he had a good personality. He was good with people. He was better than me with people. That's what I'm saying. I'm not like either one of them, I don't think.
Did you have any siblings?
Yes, I have a brother, a younger brother.
What was your favorite subject in school?
Well, all kinds of history. I loved all kinds of history.
If you could have three houses, besides the ones you already have, anywhere in the world, where would they be?
I wouldn't mind having another house in Palm Beach on Clark Avenue. Maybe a place in southern Maine. I don't need a third place.
Didn't you already have a house in Maine?
I did. It was on an island. It was not a good fit for the mailroom manager.
I've heard the house was haunted. Is that true?
Yes. My wife didn't really care that much for my relatives. John, what happened at Perfect Smiles when you went?
The initial consultation was easy. In the past, they just hand me a clipboard to fill out the forms, but that's not how I worked at Perfect Smiles. What was nice was it was a true consultation. They asked me my medical history or what I wanted to get out of the treatment plan. For me, I lived with TMJ. I'd literally have to crack my jaw throughout the day to relieve the pressure. I'd get headaches throughout the day. I'd be in pain. When I was at Perfect Smiles, they asked me what I wanted to get out of the treatment. You know, as a joke, I just said, geez, I'd love you to be able to fix my TMJ. And I was surprised because Dr. Houghton specializes in working with patients like me that have TMJ.
What were the results of visiting Dr. Houghton at Perfect Smiles?
Not only did I walk out of that office with a perfect smile, but he fixed my TMJ. It was a life-changing event. People tell me now that my smile is amazing. People would say, geez, John, your teeth look so great. I never realized my teeth looked so bad before. Now I take a look at the before and after pictures, and I'm amazed.
Go to Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire, or visit their website, perfectsmiles.com.
Joe Biden might be running for president in 2020, so we should play some of his greatest hits.
Barack and I finally reduced the disparity in sentencing, which we've been fighting to eliminate, in crack cocaine versus powder cocaine. Correct. It was a big mistake when it was made. We thought, we were told by the experts that crack, you never go back.
You cannot go to a 7-Eleven or a Dunkin' Donuts unless you have a slight Indian accent.
If you want to protect yourself, get a double barrel shotgun. If there's ever a problem, just walk out on the balcony, put that double barrel shotgun, and fire two blasts.
They're going to put you all back in chains.
Give me a break. That's a bunch of malarkey.
A three-letter word. Jobs. J-O-B-S. Jobs.
One man stands ready to deliver change we desperately need. A man I'm proud to call my friend. A man who will be the next president of the United States, Barack America.
Hi, this is Cindy from Osterville, Massachusetts.
This is Brett Rock from Dunstable, Massachusetts.
This is Amy in Lisbon Falls, Maine, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
Keep it in support our campaign. Text Joe 23. Excuse me, I got to get this right. Joe to 30330.
We're playing the musings of Grandpa Abe Simpson, you know, and about the onion belt, that kind of thing. Don't forget, though, he's also a master of authentic frontier gibberish, as he proved the other day in New Hampshire when he said that a female college student, age 21, was a lion dog-faced pony soldier. And then he claimed it was something out of a John Wayne movie or a Tyrone Power movie, or maybe it was something out of Blazing Saddles. Got it? It's here somewhere.
John, I wasn't ready for you to do
that. Oh.
Hell, I was born here, and I was raised here, and dadgummit, I'm going to die here. And no sidewinding, bushwhacking, hornswoggling, crocker crocker is going to rattle my biscuit cutter.
Now, who can argue with that?
Rabbit!
I think we're all indebted to Gabby Johnson for clearly stating what needed to be said. I'm particularly glad that these lovely children are here today to hear that speech. Not only was it authentic frontier gibberish, it expressed a courage little seen in this day and age.
Think about it. You know, that movie is like more than 40 years old now, and Joe Biden was able to give a new generation some authentic frontier gibberish in New Hampshire on Sunday afternoon. What does hornswoggling mean? Do you know, Taylor? What is hornswoggling? I've never understood that phrase.
I'm not sure. I don't know the etymology of that.
Tim, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Tim.
Hi, Howie. Thanks for taking my call.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. I just want to make a quick point. I'm Tim. I'm from Illinois, and I think the migration works both ways. We had a lot of Illinois is losing a lot of people. Probably a majority are Republicans,
right,
who are paying high taxes.
Yeah,
that might be one reason why Wisconsin flipped. You know, first time I went Republican in quite a while, '84. I want to see. If Illinois, you could probably kiss goodbye. It'll probably be Democratic.
Oh yeah, I agree.
My life.
Yeah, I agree. I remember Chuck Percy. You know, you had a Republican senator. You had a bunch of different Republican governors. Some of them ended up in the penitentiary, but you know they were still GOP, right?
Yeah.
Henry Hyde.
They were,
yeah.
Yeah, it was, you know, Dirksen, I mean, years ago, yeah. We had some strong Republicans from here. But, I mean, the flip side of that, it looks toward, you know, each party. I look in Indiana, and I was, of course, Indiana was a suburb of Gary, strong steel town, solidly Union Democratic.
Yeah.
I was in there about a year ago in a hardware store, and there was two older fellas, probably in their late 70s, early 80s, complaining that, this town was solidly Democratic years ago. You got all these outsiders moving in now. You know, you had two subdivisions going in, most of them from Illinois. So it works both ways. I guess, you know.
Don't you think a lot of the people from Illinois tend to move to the west coast of Florida too, right? I mean, they're more, you know, like East Coast is more New Hampshire, New York and Massachusetts and the Eastern Seaboard. And but a lot of Floridians, I mean, a lot of Illinois people move to the west coast. They also move to Arizona too, don't they?
Arizona and surprisingly Texas. I have three siblings who moved there.
Yeah.
And they won't move back. He said they'll never move back.
Are they Republicans, though? Are they still voting Republican, Tim?
Actually, my one sister, she's always been Democratic, and the other is kind of Libertarian.
Yeah.
You know, she'll just go with whatever. I guess it depends who's actually being gored, you know, where people are deciding to move, because I mean that could work both ways.
Yeah, I think Texas is kind of worrisome, though. What's going on? I just hope Trump can continue to bring in new voters into the Republican big tent to kind of to counter this migration from the failing states like your home state of Illinois. Nick, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Nick. You there, Nick?
California. Yeah, how you doing, Howie?
Good.
Howie, there's something rotten in Denmark, and the stench is coming right out of Indiana. March 3rd is Super Tuesday. The Indiana primary for 77 delegates is May 5th. Most states have been polling for 1 to 1.5 years. So how many Indiana polls so far? Well, we're three dark nights, say. One is the loneliest number that you'll ever know.
I don't get what you're talking about, Nick. Thanks for the call. Arthur, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Arthur.
Thanks, Charlie. There's a thing with the Flynn that hasn't, I don't think, has been publicized too well. You know, the national security, they were listening in on Flynn's conversation.
Right.
And the reason that he was hired, he was going to clean the house and get all these people out of there.
Right. And they got him before he could get them. Thanks, Arthur.
It's been more than 2 years now since I had the sleeve procedure at Newton Wellesley Hospital's Weight Loss Center. I've kept the 100 pounds off, and I'm so happy. I feel better, and I look better. I just cleaned out my clothes closet, getting rid of all those XLs and even double XLs I know I'll never fit into again. Thank goodness. If you're thinking about finally losing all that extra weight, now is the time. Call Newton Wellesley Hospital's Weight Loss Center at 617-243-3724 or go to nwh.org/weightloss. I talked to so many people who've had the procedure, and not one of them has ever said to me, Howie, I wish I'd waited a little longer to lose all this weight. Don't procrastinate any longer. Make 2019 the year you get your health back. Call 617-243-3724 or go to nwh.org/weightloss. Don't procrastinate any longer. Whatever your age, whatever your gender, do it. Call 617-243-3724 or go to nwh.org/weightloss.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Is Kennedy Babylon 2 your last book?
No, if I think of another topic for a book I want to write, I'll go for it. But I think it's the last of my Kennedy Babylon series. I made Kennedy Babylon 2 kind of long because I wanted to get everything in there. Now there's other stuff I could write about, but I'm Kennedy now.
Since having the sleeve operation, do you miss not eating big meals?
No, I don't. I can still eat what I used to eat. I just can't eat as much. I'm now very surprised how much I used to eat. I'm surprised at how much people I eat with consume. It's just hard to believe that I used to eat that much, but no, it's not a problem.
How is Mr. Gunnar since Pearl's passing?
Mr. Gunnar is drowning his sorrows in food.
What is the most trouble you ever got into as a kid?
My father was giving me grief one time up at Moosehead Lake in Maine, and I threw a rock at him. He didn't much like that.
He's the gaffe that keeps on giving. Here's 1 minute of former Vice President Joe Biden.
Your teachers who touched them, figuratively speaking, well, I hope you touch them and tell them how much you love them, too. But my point is, when you touch their hearts.
I get in trouble some things I say, but I want to tell you, just be straight up. I'm your president. For me, it starts here in my gut, goes to my heart, and then I articulate it.
And by the way, you know, I sit on the stand and it get hot. I got hairy legs that turn that turn blonde in the sun. And the kids used to come up and reach in the pool and rub my leg down so it was straight and then watch the hair come back up again. $1.2 billion. So you go ahead and you stack spaghetti sauce at a store in a supermarket. You control the guy or the woman who brings out the carts on a forklift. So I learned about roaches. I learned about kids jumping on my lap, and I've loved kids jumping on my lap.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. You get a lot of patients, I'm sure, who are apprehensive about veneers. What are some of the questions and fears you get when you're dealing with new patients?
Some people think they could look too fake, but true cosmetic dentistry is incredibly detail-oriented. So we put a lot of time and effort into individualizing how the smile looks, and we really make them look natural, but very, very pleasant.
You know, people are concerned. They wonder, you know, I got my teeth. Do I really want to put caps on?
Exactly. Yeah, they think they'll have that Hollywood look or fake look, but the technology that we have available and the artistry that we can create now really makes things so natural that most people, in fact, most dentists are just surprised that we can create what we can create nowadays. Everyone is different. Everyone has different facial dimensions, different bone structure, and we do everything we can to individualize treatment because there is no one perfect smile. It is your perfect smile.
Dr. Houghton, where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE, 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Did you have any pets when you were younger?
I had a cat named Dexter. That was my first pet. And then I had possession of two poodles when I lived in Palm Beach, Princess and Frisky. They weren't really my dogs, but I took care of them. They lived with me. So they were my dogs. I love those poodles.
When you were a kid, what was the best gift you ever received?
I got this wooden fort from FAO Schwartz in Palm Beach, about the age of 6 or 7, 10 soldiers to go along with it. Such a cool fort. I had that fort for like maybe close to 10 years.
What is your all-time favorite movie?
Probably Goodfellas. I love Goodfellas. I love it even more than The Godfather.
What is your favorite dessert?
Oh, that's a tough one. Probably chocolate ice cream, followed by vanilla ice cream, followed by coffee ice cream.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
You are known as a cheap bastard. Which one of your daughters is the cheapest and why?
Charlotte is the cheapest, and I say that because she's always using my credit card. We keep changing the credit cards over and over again, and she keeps busting in and using them again. Most recently, just this week, she spent $75 at AT&T.
What's the cheapest thing you do now to save money?
The cheapest thing I do currently to save money, I guess, is I take all the bottles and cans back to the market basket every weekend. I always like to save that money. You know, I can't stand to throw those bottles and cans away and have the unclaimed returns go to the state of Massachusetts for illegal aliens.
Do you recycle?
Yes, I do recycle. When I got on the town meeting, I saw that the town dump was probably the only department
There's
in the town
audio
that was running
of,
in the black.
Rush,
because of all the recycling
caller,
that was going on.
Called
so
in
I
and
try
asked
to talk
to Snurtley so he could donate a lung.
You are
going to get the lung to the doctor when he finds out what the caller wanted.
This is What'd you the say? Howie Carr Show live from Chappaquiddick. At
I'm sorry.
The There's audio of Rush who's doing a show today.
Yeah.
And, I don't know if you're listening.
Oh, no, I was, actually.
News Talk 850.
Yeah.
And then he finds out what the caller wanted to talk to Snurtley about. The caller wanted to donate one of his lungs. We get some motion.
Oh, okay. No, that's good. You want to play that, Cut? That's a good one.
Yeah, we can play that.
Yeah. Did you talk to Victor Davis Hanson?
No, I haven't had a chance to do that yet.
Okay, see if you can get him tomorrow or something. That column he wrote on Rush was really great. He really did the best job I've seen. Yeah.
Your belief is
sure
that while Ted Kennedy was walking past all these houses.
Oh, is there something going on YouTube? Is there someone making inappropriate remarks?
That's just a spam account. They try to get people to sign up for, you know, webcam chats. They're trying to sell sex. I've deleted them.
Oh, okay. Okay, good. Thanks.
The Subaru of New England, Washington's birthday sales event lasts all month long. Feel the freedom in the all-new all-wheel drive 2020 Subaru Outback with standard LED headlights, starting at only $26,645.
Did you see that 978 make 2019 months, the year for your weight loss? Did you see that?
Oh yeah.
We got to do that. Okay, thanks. SubaruofNewEngland.com. And send the guy a message and tell him thanks too.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate. Howie Carr.
So now you've broken your elbow. Have you ever broken any other bones?
When I was 8 years old, I broke my leg.
Dad.
I was playing touch football in Portland, and a big kid, a 15-year-old, tackled me.
Howie.
I was in my 30s. I was going
somebody
downstairs.
Somebody wants to say hello.
Who wants to say hello? The stairs. And I who's this? On it and
broke Carolyn.
Hey, what are you doing? Hey, what are you doing there, Carolyn?
Mom says she's going to farmhouse.
Just out of Deerfield. I got smacked in the jaw. You wanted a free meal?
I still have a bridge.
I don't
around
like 20 minutes to that.
You're getting another free meal a week from tonight, right? We're going to the club for dinner, right?
When do you plan to retire?
I want to go to the beach, but I don't want to go to Mar-a-Lago.
On retiring,
you want to go where?
I want to go to the beach club, not the Mar-a-Lago.
There's only one big moment.
Okay, now I understand. You know, I get it.
I also want to go to the fish restaurant.
Amendment number 2 in the Bill of Rights.
You want to go to the fish restaurant rather than Trevini's?
Being necessary to the security of the free state, the right of the people to keep and
she said it's not very good.
Be infringed.
Up in
you have the right to bear arms.
Oh, the Jupiter. Oh, in Jupiter. I thought you meant the one on Sunset.
No.
Oh, okay. No, we can go up to the Captain Reefers. You made.
Better strap yourself in. It's time
okay, we can go there.
The Howie Carr Show.
I plan on trying to win New Hampshire. I'm not here to come in second.
Both Elizabeth Warren and Joe Biden will not meet that 15% threshold. And as a result, they will be shut out of pledged delegates in the state of New Hampshire tonight.
We're going to be back in New Hampshire. We're going to be back there to defeat Donald Trump in November.
Nobody under 10% at this point in the process has ever went on to win the nomination and has ever really been, you know, competitive at the end.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
So something has happened in the last 48 hours. People have told me that they're giving Amy Klobuchar a second look.
I wonder why.
I am not going to sugarcoat it. We took a gut punch in Iowa.
You're a lying dog-faced pony soldier.
You cannot have 20, 30, 40, 50 clips in a weapon.
Are you concerned about the message that you're sending to New Hampshire by going to South Carolina?
Not at all. And why are you so negative? I'm not getting up on New Hampshire. Don't poke that in my face, okay, buddy?
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
You know, we're counting on having the wind of New Hampshire at our backs. I've got a reservation to fly on to South Carolina tomorrow afternoon.
I am so sorry. That flight is canceled.
Former Massachusetts Governor Deval Patrick is expected to suspend his campaign.
And Diane and I are going to go home and rest and reflect on this outcome.
We're going to be fine.
You know, I am the math guy. And it is clear tonight from the numbers that we are not going to win this race. I am suspending my campaign for president.
Unchained and unstoppable.
President Trump last night had the highest voter turnout of any incumbent in 4 decades. He also had the highest percent of the vote of any incumbent in the past 4 decades. The enthusiasm's on President Trump's side. Democrats, by the way, have a dumpster fire.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moonbats beware. It's Howie Carr.
Let's keep that dumpster fire burning for the Democrats. That's all I got to say. I like that kind of evening that we had last night, watching them all their hair on fire. Basically, they were out of control. Before we go to the chump line, I just got to play this one cut. Morning Joe. Former Republican congressman from Pensacola, married to Mika Brzezinski, daughter of Zygmunt Brzezinski, the failed national security advisor for Jimmy Carter. And they used to be buddies with Trump. They would hang out at the Mar-a-Lago club. And Joe would just hover around the bar. And now Morning Joe is in the throes of a terminal case of Trump derangement syndrome. Cut 26.
We are our constitutional republic, literally, and the institutions in it literally are being challenged every single day by this would-be dictator. I mean, basically, that sounds tough, doesn't it? You tell
That's
me.
That's the word I
you
was going to use.
Does Donald Trump, would Donald Trump not do whatever he could do if he could get away with it? Seriously, if he could arrest every journalist he didn't like, if he could arrest us tomorrow, let me ask you a question. Do you think he would arrest us tomorrow? Do you think he would arrest the editor of the New York Times, the editor of the Washington Post, Jeff Bezos? Do you think he'd arrest them tomorrow and throw them in jail to silence them?
Like it.
Do you think they would? Because if you say he wouldn't, you're just lying to yourself.
Does he really think Donald Trump cares enough to arrest him and Mika? He's watching Fox and Friends. Okay. Joe, all he wants you to do is pay your bar tab at Mar-a-Lago. You know, how many freebies did he give you over the years? Good Lord. A megalomania, paranoia, and Trump derangement syndrome. He's got the trifecta of mental maladies of 2020. Time now for the Chump Line.
Could I get me a beer to cry in?
Can I give me a blanket to send up some smoke signals saying I need some more wampum, please? Send me some more money for my campaign.
Could this be an opportunity for a new cookbook, Bow Wow Chow?
Of course, her old cookbook was Pow Wow Chow with those great Trail of Tears recipes like cold crab omelet, a favorite of the Duke and Duchess of Windsor and Noel Coward, well-known Indian chiefs of yesteryear. The Chump Line is brought to you every weekday at this time by Matthews Brothers, America's oldest window manufacturer. This week, remembering a simpler time in America. When counting votes was basic arithmetic, Hollywood celebrities knew their job was to play make-believe, and politicians didn't yell at the voters. Fear not, we still make wicked awesome windows.
Howie, Joe Biden calling. Come on, man. Why are you so negative? Of course I didn't stick around. The fact is, everyone knew Bernie would win his home state of Vermont last night, period. Now I'm campaigning in South Carolina at your alma mater, NC State. I mean it.
That really was Joe Biden. Yeah, I know. Someone says, I would like a straitjacket on Morning Joe. Somebody should, for his sake, get him some Haldol. So let me get this straight. According to Mika, a dictator has to ask permission to arrest them. Okay, got it. No, literally. Did you hear him say that? Literally. He's trying to destroy him. He doesn't want to lock somebody up for 7 to 9 years for a processed crime, and there's no underlying crime beneath it. And that makes him literally a dictator. Okay, I got it, Morning Joe.
People get 30-year car loans all the time. As a matter of fact, I just refinanced mine for a car improvement loan. I needed brakes and rotors.
We haven't played that cut for a while. We might as well play it just here. Cut 27. This is Katie Turr from MSNBC. Not the brightest bulb on the Christmas tree. She was with Chris Sununu, the governor of New Hampshire, yesterday, and she's going to tell you something about a kind of car loan you've never heard of before. Cut 27.
When I ask people if they're voting for Donald Trump, I hear about the 401ks a lot. That's a number I hear. 401k, my 401k is doing great. But there are those out there who don't have a 401k. And there are those out there who this economy is not really working for. They might have a job, but it's not a job that pays their bills. They can get a car, but it's a loan that'll last them 30 years. They can't buy a house. The economy's not working in a way that makes their lives function properly.
Well, you're spinning that message in a state with the lowest poverty rate in the country. We've made it lower. One of the lowest unemployment rates. We have more jobs and families moving into New Hampshire than ever before, more working people than ever before.
I wish I had known that that exchange took place when we had Chris Sununu on last night. I would have asked him, Chris, how did you keep a straight face when she talked about the 30-year car loan?
Lion, dog face, pony soldier, reporting for duty, sir.
Yeah. Leaving before the polls closed in New Hampshire, that was definitely the move of a lying pony, lying dog-faced pony soldier.
Hey, Howie, I bet you Bailey knows what state he's in.
Again, hashtag praying for Bailey or hashtag save Bailey. You know what happened? The dog in the book, the last hurrah, that dog, it was rented by the guy who knocked out the James Michael Curley figure. It was a rented Irish setter. Do we know if Bailey really belongs to the fake Indian, or is Bailey rented? And if Bailey is Bailey rented by the week or by the month?
A beautiful dog, a talented dog.
Howard, Bill Well calling. Say what you will about New Hampshire, but any night I end up above 0.08% is a good night.
Yeah, he under the old laws, he got 9% or let's make it 09. Say 09. In the old days, he could drive away. But they changed the OUI laws. Now anything over eight is considered impaired. So he was campaigning buzzed, or he was polling buzzed, I guess you could say, last night.
Well, as Joe Biden wished, he didn't get second in New Hampshire.
That's true. You know, he's now been in three presidential races and he has yet to win a primary. Of course, most of the time he's knocked out of the race before the primaries even begin.
A communist, a gay mayor, and a fake Indian. Name three things that will never be president of the United States.
I've got to read you some of these stories about Klobuchar with her staff, too. That's pretty bad. People seem to have forgotten that. Got a little play when she got into the race last year, but it's kind of been subsumed. Maybe because she's this week's great white hope, so to speak, of the Democrat Party.
General Motors is alive, and Osama bin Laden and Joe Biden's presidential campaign are dead.
Yeah, he just doesn't know it yet. He's like a zombie. He's wandering around that he doesn't know that his campaign is over.
Elizabeth Warren, a liar and a phony. I'm Bailey the Golden Retriever, and I approve this message.
Watch it, Bailey. Watch it.
That was your last chump line message. Thank you for calling Howie Carr, you chump.
I wonder if she's paying the tax on Bailey. I assume you have to pay one in Cambridge. When I lived in Cambridge, I didn't have a dog, but in Wellesley, I have to pay $12 a year for Gunnar. You know, that's the town, you know, tax or fee assessment on a dog. I wonder if she pays her taxes. She never paid her excise tax on her car until I made an inquiry in 2012 when she was first running for the Senate. Then she had her aides rushed down to City Hall to pay off the excise taxes. All right, that's it for the Chump Line today. The Chump Line is the recorded voicemail message service of the Howie Carr Show. You can call and leave a message at any hour of the day or night, including weekends. The Chump Line number, if you'd like to leave such a message, 844-500-4242, 844-500-4242. Press 2 for the Chump Line. Leave your message. We may or may not play it at this time each weekday. The Chump Line is brought to you by Matthews Brothers, America's oldest window manufacturer. This week, remembering a simpler time in America when counting votes was basic arithmetic, Hollywood celebrities knew their job was to play make-believe, and politicians didn't yell at the voters. Fear not. We still make wicked awesome windows.
Could this be an opportunity for a new cookbook, Bow Wow Chow?
Or she could just bring Bailey out and have people take selfies with Bailey. I guess people do like to take, according to her, they like to take pictures with Bailey. I'd rather take a picture with Bailey than with her, myself. 844-500-4242. Do you think Liz Warren registered her dog in Newport, Rhode Island? That's a good one, 603. Like John Kerry registered his boat down in Rhode Island to avoid the excise tax. I'm Howie Carr.
You can call him Fat Boy, just don't call him late for dinner. It's Howie Carr.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Nauset Beach Inn. From May 1st to June 19th, get an ocean view room at half price, only $150. Go to NausetBeachInn.com and click special offers. That's NausetBeachInn.com.
We at Matthews Brothers would like to send a wicked huge thank you to our dealers, their customers, and their customers' customers for supporting us as we set yet another sales record in our relentless march towards global domination. Over the past 10 years, while the U.S. window market has grown 3-4% annually, Matthews Brothers has consistently surpassed the industry rate, including an amazing sevenfold increase in 2019. There are a lot of reasons for this growth, but to us it comes down to just one word, trust. Trust and confidence. Two words, trust, confidence, and loyalty. Okay, three words. Trust that comes from 166 years of providing consistently superior customer service. Confidence that our builder customers have in recommending and using our products in their projects. And the loyalty from our dealers who service builders and contractors from the Atlantic Ocean to the New York border, or as we call it, the Western Frontier. You can learn more about our authentic, wicked awesome Maine made products, but only at Better Lumber Yards and Window Professionals or on the web at MatthewsBrothers.com. Matthews Brothers with one T, America's oldest window manufacturer.
I'm the Vice President of the United States.
Love him or hate him, Joe Biden's here for the long haul, but we can't get enough of his gaffes. Here's the best of Uncle Joe's speaking before he thinks.
We choose truth over facts.
When the stock market crashed, Franklin Roosevelt got on television.
Make sure you have the record player on at night.
Poor kids are just as bright and just as talented as white kids.
Okay, well, all right. Well, you can frack with me later, okay?
The teachers are recon. I'm married to a teacher. My deceased wife is a teacher.
Yeah, we?
And Corn
yes.
Pop was a bad dude.
Governor LePage is on the line. I've known
okay, Christmas. What do you want to talk about?
Three of them. I don't know. He says he's driving up from Florida listening.
Go to Joe.
Oh, that's great. I'm glad. Okay, I'll put him on.
330 and help me.
Had over 40 kids shot at Kent State on a beautiful lawn.
I love this place. Look, what's not to like about Vermont in terms of the beauty of it?
I said something that was not meant the way I said.
I mean, what is it that I said wrong?
I want to be clear. I'm not going nuts. Anyway, my time's up. I'm sorry.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain in peace of mind by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
we went to the White House for the Christmas party. In your opinion, what was the highlight?
The highlight of my trip to the White House with Grace, there were two. Number one, when we walked into Trump International Hotel, which she'd been dreaming of going to, and her eyes were wide. And then when the president actually came down the stairs, her eyes were even wider. She was so in awe of being there. I really felt like King Farouk, you know? I felt like I was giving someone a really great gift that they couldn't get otherwise.
You've had some really good interviews over the years. Which one was your favorite?
I can't really say what the best interview I ever had, but one that just occurred to me was Jesse Helms, the senator from North Carolina. I interviewed him one time, and he went to high school with my mother in Monroe, North Carolina. And the first words out of his mouth were, "Howie, I know your mother before you knew your mother."
This is Kevin from Brockton.
This is Karen from Boiling Springs, South Carolina.
This is Officer Mark calling from beautiful Stratford County, New Hampshire. And this is the Howie Carr Show.
844-500-4242. Joining us now on the line is Paul LePage, the former governor of the great state of Maine. Governor LePage, what's going on?
I'm driving up, bringing my sports car up to store it until spring, and I'm going to do some Lincoln Day dinners next week and tell the people, get the Republicans wound up so that they don't forget there's an election this year.
Oh, I don't think anybody's going to forget. Is the second congressional district going to deliver a one vote for Donald Trump, you think?
I believe so. I believe he's got a really good chance of winning the entire state.
Really?
I really believe that the people in northern Massachusetts are really dumbfounded. You know, they can't make up their mind.
Northern Massachusetts, you mean the part of Maine that I was born in?
Yeah, the first district.
I believe you got a few votes out of my neck of the woods, you know?
I actually did. You know, the first election, I lost Portland by 15,000 votes. The second election, I lost it by 7,000 votes. So we actually made some big penetrations in the second, in the first district in the second election. And, you know, right now, I think it's positioning. The state is really concerned. The governor, the new governor increased the budget by $1 billion, and now she's asking for a supplemental of up to $800 million. So that's 1.8 billion increase in a year, which is more than the cash I had saved up.
At least she came out basically against TCI, Transportation Climate Initiative, that the double gas tax that Charlie Baker is promoting.
Yeah, I am hoping she's against it because she initially came out against it after all the hoopla. But, you know, the jury's still out. She has a habit of, I guess I call it being morally flexible with the truth.
Yeah, I know. I must say I'm worried about that too. But you know, apparently Virginia is going to pull out of it too, or not pull out of it, but they were never in it. But they're going to just sort of renounce it. So I don't think it's going anywhere except maybe Massachusetts. Do you think the president should come up to Bangor again to campaign, or do you think he's got bigger fish to fry?
Absolutely.
Yeah,
he's got bigger fish to fry. But I think I think a visit to Bangor and a visit to Portland in 2020, this year, would do an awful lot to get him the whole state, because the Mainers are really upset with the impeachment, the sham that it was created. They're quite upset with a certain senator we have.
That's what was going to be my next question. At least she voted against the article. She voted for the witnesses, but she voted against the both articles. Unlike the former governor of Massachusetts, Mitt Romney.
Yeah, right. I just couldn't understand anybody that could vote for that. There was a GOP. I mean, to me, there's a lot of that has a lot to do with not getting a secretary's job, you know.
Yeah, exactly. Secretary of State.
He's just a bitter man.
Are you?
Yeah, he's just a bitter guy.
Are you going to? Are you going to run for governor again? People want it. I'm getting deluged with text messages. They want you to run for governor again.
Yeah, well, that's what I'm up here for. We're exploring. I'm looking into it, and that's why I am going to work very, very hard this year to get Trump elected and to get the House and the Senate rolled over into the Republican ranks so that she can't do any more damage.
Hey, Governor LePage, always a pleasure. Please feel free to call in again. Stay safe. Talk to you soon. That's Paul LePage, the former governor. Maybe the future governor. I'm Howie Carr.
Are you looking for a pre-owned car? Well, before you go to the dealership where you'll be pounced on by pushy salespeople, give the car guys a try. I'm Bill Papa George, and my job is to make finding the perfect used car as easy as possible. That means I do all of the tough legwork for you. Once I figure out what you want out of a car, I go find it. I've been in this business for a long time, and I know what to look out for. I won't bring you a car unless I know it will meet or exceed your expectations. So give me a call at 800-300-4600. That is 800-300-4600.
Hey, business owners and marketing professionals, would you like to advertise on the Howie Carr Radio Network? Howie's show reaches all across New England. And you know who's listening? Your next customer, client, or business lead. If you're interested in advertising on the Howie Carr Show, call 800-227-7300. That's 800-227-7300. You're listening to Howie, and so is your next customer. Call 800-227-7300 right now.
The Democrat Party is so full of loony social justice warriors, progressives, whatever you want to call them, that sometimes certain moonbats get overlooked. So let's take this moment to shine the woke spotlight on Crazy Maisie Hirono.
I am not going to be a fool to Mitch McConnell's shenanigans. Why should any of us?
And it's not just a dog whistle, it's a bullhorn.
Bullhorns. It's racism. It's basically, for many people, it's anti-Semitic. It's white supremacy.
Why not take a stand and vote yes for it? Seems like you're trying to have it both ways. Not be hung by it politically, but also not say that you don't support it.
I disagree with you, Katie, that why should we engage in the kind of sham shenanigans that Mitch McConnell is really good at?
I'm confused.
This was just a sham.
Guess who's perpetuating all of these kinds of actions? It's the men in this country. And I just want to say to the men in this country, just shut up and step up.
I think the noose is closing. And, you know, Giuliani is like a loose cannon. And so is the president, frankly.
I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. Dr. Houghton, tell us about the state-of-the-art procedures that can help many people look 10 to 15 years younger.
As we age, we do lose these proper proportions to our faces. And so if you're deficient in your chin or mid-face, we can create the proper proportions and make you look great. Sometimes we use orthodontics to change the look of the face. Sometimes we just use the teeth themselves, and it creates the right support for a beautiful face. They're all non-surgical procedures.
There's some pretty complex cases that you deal with. Give me an example of a tough case.
Well, some cases, people just are missing a lot of teeth. I get a lot of people that come in and think that I cannot solve their problems because they're too great, but I really can. We've been doing this for over 35 years, and there isn't much that we haven't seen.
So even if you're missing a few teeth, or your teeth are discolored, or you're very embarrassed, there's no reason not to come in for a consultation, right?
Absolutely. New techniques, new technology, things are available to us that we never had before, and we can handle just about everything.
Where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE.
He's the gaffe that keeps on giving. Here's 1 minute of former Vice President Joe Biden.
You teachers who touched them, figuratively speaking, well, I hope you touch them and tell them how much you love them, too. But my point is, when you touch their hearts.
I get in trouble some things I say, but I want to tell you, just be straight up. If I'm your president, with me, it starts here in my gut, goes to my heart, and then I articulate it.
And by the way, you know, I sit on the stand and it get hot. I got hairy legs that turn blonde in the sun. And the kids used to come up and reach in the pool and rub my leg down so it was straight, and then watch the hair come back up again. $1.2 billion. So you go ahead and you stack spaghetti sauce at a store in a supermarket. You control the guy or the woman who brings out the carts on a forklift. So I learned about roaches. I learned about kids jumping on my lap, and I've loved kids jumping on my lap.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate. Howie Carr.
Is Kennedy Babylon 2 your last book?
No, if I think of another topic for a book I want to write, I'll go for it. But I think it's the last of my Kennedy Babylon series. I made Kennedy Babylon 2 kind of long because I wanted to get everything in there. Now there's other stuff I could write about, but I'm Kennedy now.
Since having the sleeve operation, do you miss not eating big meals?
No, I don't. I can still eat what I used to eat. I just can't eat as much. I'm now very surprised how much I used to eat. I'm surprised at how much people I eat with consume. It's just hard to believe that I used to eat that much, but no, it's not a problem.
How is Mr. Gunnar since Pearl's passing?
Mr. Gunnar is drowning his sorrows in food.
What is the most trouble you ever got into as a kid?
My father was giving me grief one time at the Moosehead Lake in Maine, and I threw a rock at him. He didn't much like that.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studio.
Don't forget, when he first ran, I called him 1% Joe, because every time he ran, he only got 1%. And then Obama took him off the garbage heap. But he only got 1%, right, John? You know that. 1% Joe. But now he's, 19% Joe? It's better. He's doing better. He's made a lot of progress.
19%. Would that it were, as John Kerry would say, 19%. Amy Klobuchar got more votes than the fake Indian and Creepy Joe combined. How pathetic is that for Creepy Joe and the fake Indian? Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company that I trust. Give them a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Which dog would you have voted for to win the Westminster Dog Show? Seba the Standard Poodle or Daniel the Golden Retriever?
I'm going with the poodle, Seba. I like poodles.
Seba's only got 12%.
Really?
Daniel's 88.
Not that I don't like golden retrievers, but I'm for poodles. Okay. All right. 844-500-4242. We told you yesterday, Jussie Smollett, the black gay quote-unquote actor who faked a hate crime last year. He's been indicted again. Kim Fox, the state's attorney for Cook County, Chicago, broomed the case at the behest of the powers that be, some of whom have deep connections to the Obamas. And so now Jussie Smollett has been indicted again. And right in the midst of Kim Fox's reelection campaign, apparently. And so would you care to guess who she's blaming, the indictment by the special prosecutor Dan Webb on? Taylor, I'll bet you can guess who really indicted Jussie Smollett to embarrass Kim Fox in the run-up to her reelection bid.
I couldn't hazard a guess, Howie.
Oh, I think you could. I'm going to read you a quote. It's very a mixed message, kind of confusing, but you know, she's trying to get all the main players in. What's questionable here, she said, is the James Comey-like timing of that charging decision just 35 days before an election, which can only be interpreted as the further politicization of the justice system, something voters in the era of, wait for it, Donald Trump should consider offensive.
Boy, Roger Stone's going to skate and Jussie's going to hang. Oh, sorry, I shouldn't have said that.
Fox has made her opposition to Trump a hallmark of her reelection campaign. You don't say. What a surprise. Airing commercials touting her success in, quote, standing up to the administration on the issue of immigration. Maybe she should be standing up to the gangs and the gangbangers in Chicago who are murdering hundreds of her constituents every year in the Windy City. So she's blaming that on Trump, of course. By the way, did you hear about the Jacksonville hate crime? they mentioned it briefly. There's a guy who looks a lot like Bill Weld's son, and he drove into, there was a Republican voter registration drive in a Walmart parking lot in Jacksonville, Florida, Duval County. And so he admitted to the cops after he was stopped. He didn't kill anybody, but he tried to. He tried to run them down, these Republicans, in a voter registration tent. He admitted that he tried to run them down. So the headlines, though, they don't call it a hate crime because it's a guy who was trying to kill Republicans. Here's a there's a headline I picked up on the internet today. Florida man who struck Republican voter tent motivated by Trump opposition. Do you think if it were a Trump supporter who's running into a Democrat voter registration tent, they'd call it an opposition, or would they call it a hate crime? Animus is another word that has shown up. Anyway, before we go back to the phone lines at 844-500-4242, there was a touching moment today on the Rush Limbaugh show. Yeah, you know, he's going to be out the next couple of days again for the, as he begins his treatment for advanced lung cancer. But he was back today, and after he took a call from a guy who was a fan, Bo Snerdly, his producer, was speaking to the guy. And I guess, is that where we can pick it up, Taylor?
Yeah, he covers it all right.
Okay, here it is.
And when you're done with me, if I could talk to you, Mr. Snerdly, briefly.
Well, okay, I'm done with you. I'm done with you. Snerdly wants to talk to you. All right, so we'll take a brief timeout, my friends, and be back. Wrap up the hour right after this. Don't go away. I just asked Snerdly. You got a madness. I just asked Snerdly, that was through talking to me, he wanted to talk to you. And Snerdly did not hesitate, did not drop a beat, said he wanted to donate a lung. You wanted one. And, oh, wow. Wow, okay. That would have been, I thought he was making arrangements to call back in, you know, trying to grease the skids to get in again. Well, I thought, I don't, you all just continue to stop me dead in my tracks. I continue to get emails and flowers and cards. I mean, it's voluminous. And it is so touching. I mean, people recounting experiences they had 30 years ago, 25 years ago. And this is why I said last Friday, last week, that how lucky I am. And people have trouble understanding that, but believe me, everything that's happened to me is a blessing. And I hear things like that and I don't know what to do with it.
That was Rush Limbaugh this afternoon. He got a guy, you just heard it, offered to give him a lung, one of his lungs, if he needed a lung transplant. It was a very touching moment. And Victor Davis Hanson has a really top-notch piece about Rush Limbaugh and what he's meant to everybody over the years. And I tweeted it out. We're going to try to get Victor Davis Hanson on. He's had a couple of great columns, one about the deep state and this other one about Rush's career. And I didn't realize that Victor Davis Hanson was such a student of talk radio, as he is of so many things. But he has a really good inside understanding of just how important Rush Limbaugh has been to talk radio. And as he said in his piece, And it's something usually mostly people, you know, who are just inside the business know. Rush Limbaugh came along and it's not like he destroyed talk radio when he took it over and became the transforming figure, the transcendent figure in talk radio. He made it so that hundreds of us could be more effective. As Victor Davis Hanson says, there were a lot of effective local, regional talk radio hosts, but Rush made it a national phenomenon, and he enabled a lot of us to go somewhat national, even though we kept our local or our regional roots. And it was just a very perceptive piece. And we're going to try to get Victor Davis Hanson on. And if you haven't, maybe we should retweet it again, Taylor, so people can see it. If you follow me at Howie Carr Show, you can get the link. It's just a really good piece, and you really appreciate Rush after a night like this last one. You know, when you want to see his take on because it's humorous. You know, he has his own wry take on the foibles of the other side, especially. 844-500-4242. Monique, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Monique.
Hi, Howie.
Hi.
I called to talk about Amy Klobuchar.
Yes.
But that's remarkable. What the gentleman caller said to Rush.
Yeah.
So on the opposite end of the spectrum, actually, I'm really pleased that you've raised the issue of how Amy Klobuchar has treated her staff. That this has been infuriating me ever since I read about it. And I went back, actually, funny, you raised it yesterday, and she's been doing this for 15 years.
Right.
And she has the worst staff retention rate in the Senate.
Yeah.
So lest anybody think that we're being sexist or anything like that, that the number speaks for itself.
No, this is let me read you the headline. I'll read it more when we come back from the break. But this is the headline in Vanity Fair. And it tells, this is Vanity Fair's, this is where they're coming from. The worst thing you can do at Vanity Fair land is to compare people to Donald Trump. Terrified aides say Amy Klobuchar is just like Trump. But you're right. I mean, the whole incident with the comb and the salad, that goes back to 2008. That's a long time ago now, Monique, you know, that she's been behaving exactly in this fashion, you know?
And that incident alone, that would just be funny and weird, but it's the way she treats her staff, and she screams at them and she demeans them, and she does it publicly. And it's not really, doesn't sound like it's constructive criticism. She just vents on them.
Right.
And it's really, you know, it just speaks volumes about her character, and on that basis, she has a really bad character. You're judged by how you treat people, including how you treat your coworkers, your boss, and your staff, in particular your staff. Right. And she treats them very badly.
I'll read you one thing before we go to the break here. This is from the BuzzFeed story. I've always been taught that your true character shows in how you treat those with less power than you, especially behind closed doors. The way Senator Klobuchar behaves in private with her staff is very different than when she's in the public eye. And that kind of cruelty shouldn't be acceptable for anyone. See, that's the thing about Trump, Monique. I mean, you know, they got a picture of him coming onto Air Force One or coming off Air Force One, and he had a $20 bill sticking out of his pocket. And, one of the reporters said, well, why you got $20? You're the president. Why you got $20 bills in your pocket? And he said, I like to give tips. You know, I mean, he's a well-regarded figure at his resorts, because he takes care of people. He asks them how they're doing. He's got cash. He hands them money. You think Amy Klobuchar does any of that? Hell no. Hell no. Thanks for the call, Monique. 844-500-4242. One of every guy's greatest fears is waking up on Valentine's Day and realizing you completely forgot, or you neglected it is more likely. Do not blow it this year. Valentine's Day is just 2 days away. If you haven't ordered roses, you need to act fast with the official florist of Valentine's, 1-800-Flowers.com. Today only, you can get the 24-stem colorful rose medley for only $29.99. That's right, the 24-stem colorful rose medley. I'm holding it right now for only $29.99, or upgrade to 24 red roses for only $10 more. This is great. Grace loved getting these flowers in Boston. These came to the mailroom manager down here in Florida. Taylor was counting on taking home the bouquet to Grace and giving it to his wife. But now he's going to have to order his own from 1-800-Flowers. Because
I know some people at Newsmax. I can drive down to Boca.
You can
take
get
some of those flowers.
Get
off
Paula
your desk.
Page to turn around and come down here and pick
That's
up
exactly
the flowers.
Who I was going to call. He's in a sports car. He can make a quick trip.
Look at these flowers, though. They're really beautiful, and they're picked right at the peak of their freshness. And your significant other wants. She may say she doesn't want flowers, but she does. Believe me, you know it, and I know it. And she wants them delivered to her workplace so that she can impress her friends. Roses from 1-800-Flowers are picked at their peak and shipped overnight to ensure freshness. The 24-stem colorful rose medley for only $29.99, or an upgrade to 24 red roses for just $10 more, is one of the best Valentine's offers you'll find, but it expires today and while supplies last. Pick your delivery date and let 1-800-Flowers handle the rest. When it comes to impressing her on Valentine's, trust in the Rose Authority, 1-800-Flowers.com. To order the 24-stem colorful rose medley for $29.99 or upgrade to 24 red roses for only $10 more, go to 1-800-Flowers.com, click the radio icon, and enter code Howie. Order today and save at 1-800-Flowers.com, code Howie. Hurry, offer expires today. I'm Howie Carr.
Don't touch that dial. Howie Carr will be back after this.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you today in part by Rejuven Ice Cryo in Peabody. Bring down inflammation and increase energy at Rejuven Ice Cryo at 194 Newberry Street in Peabody, Massachusetts. The Moonbats always say Donald Trump isn't very bright. But what about Barack Hussein Obama? Let's listen to some of his greatest hits.
I've now been in 57 states. I think one left to go. I don't know what the term is in Austrian.
The Cambridge police act stupidly.
And there has never been any man or woman more qualified for this office than Hillary Clinton.
There are neighborhoods around the country where it is easier for a 12 or 13 year old to purchase a gun and cheaper than it is for them to get a book.
I believe in the Second Amendment. It's there written on the paper.
If we fall for, you know, a bunch of okie doke.
A few months ago, when you were asked what's the biggest geopolitical threat facing America, you said Russia, not Al Qaeda. You said Russia in the 1980s or now. Calling to ask for their foreign policy back.
John, what happened at Perfect Smiles when you went?
The initial consultation was easy. In the past, they just hand me a clipboard to fill out the forms, but that's not how I worked at Perfect Smiles. What was nice was it was a true consultation. They asked me my medical history or what I wanted to get out of the treatment plan. For me, I lived with TMJ. I'd literally have to crack my jaw throughout the day to relieve the pressure. I'd get headaches throughout the day. I'd be in pain. When I was at Perfect Smiles, they asked me what I wanted to get out of the treatment. You know, as a joke, I just said, geez, I'd love you to be able to fix my TMJ. And I was surprised because Dr. Houghton specializes in working with patients like me that have TMJ.
What were the results of visiting Dr. Houghton at Perfect Smiles?
Not only did I walk out of that office with a perfect smile, but he fixed my TMJ. It was a life-changing event. People tell me now that my smile is amazing. People would say, geez, John, your teeth look so great. I never realized my teeth looked so bad before. Yep. Now I take a look at before and after pictures, and I'm amazed.
Go to Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire, or visit their website, perfectsmiles.com.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
How did you come up with the name VB?
My first producer and I both had steady girlfriends, or we were married or whatever. And VB was always saying that we were whipped. You know what I mean? Finally, I said, you don't even have a girlfriend. I've never seen you with a female. As a matter of fact, I don't think you have ever had sex. You are just a virgin boy.
What is your biggest fear.
That Donald Trump will not be reelected in 2020 and that some horrible Democrat will come in and finish off the destruction of this once great country.
Out of all of your daughters, who is the least like you and why?
Probably Charlotte, even though we went to the same high school, Deerfield Academy. She has a different sense of her responsibilities than I do. Let me put it that way. She has a different regard for money. She's not a cheap bastard, in other words.
This is Deb in Danielson, Connecticut.
This is Greg in Boston, Mass.
This is Elizabeth in Wakefield, Massachusetts, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
I admired Senator Sanders when I was a high school student. I respect him greatly to this day, and I congratulate him on his strong showing tonight.
Yeah, he's kind of, you know, giving him the back of his hand, pointing out how old he is, you know. That's what that's all about. 844-500-4242. Jerry Williams always used to get the guy, my predecessor here, and speaking of, you know, the great regional talk show host, pre-Rush. And every time Mike Dukakis would do something similar to him, it'd say, you know, Jerry, I used to listen to you when I was at college. Where did he go? He went somewhere down in Pennsylvania. Not Buck. Now he went to, I forget where he went, but he went to, and it always say, I listened to you when I was in college. And Jerry would always like recoil when he would hear something like that. Cause he knew he was getting the needle, but I always thought, you know, what's the deal? You know, you can't do anything about the birthdays. Anyway, let me read you some stuff about Klobuchar here. At least three people turned down the opportunity to manage Klobuchar's campaign due to her reputation for cruelty and repeated emotional abuse. People seem to have forgotten this. This is a story from Vanity Fair last year, and this is just a compilation of earlier stories. Last year, meaning 2018, the New York Times noted that on Capitol Hill, Ms. Klobuchar's reputation is not all sweetness and light. A March 2018 article in Politico described Klobuchar as, quote, among the worst bosses in Congress with the highest office turnover rate in the Senate. BuzzFeed reviewed emails often sent between 1 and 4 in the morning in which Klobuchar, quote, regularly berated employees, often in all capital letters, over minor mistakes, misunderstandings, and misplaced commas. Klobuchar in the emails, which were mostly sent over the past few years, referred to her staff's work as the worst in years, the worst in my life. That anger regularly left employees in tears, four former staffers said. She yelled through papers and sometimes even hurled objects. One aide was accidentally hit with a flying binder. Harry Reid had to privately tell her to lay off the staffers. I'm Howie Carr. Campers, have you thought of upgrading your RV or camper this year? This is Howie Carr. Right now at Cold Springs RV, you can shop great preseason deals on a brand new 2020 camper. Go see the latest in pop-ups, travel trailers, fifth wheels, toy haulers, and motor homes. Cold Springs RV is your one-stop shop with over 200 acres of all things camping. It started with a camp resort, then came the RV center and superstore. Now they have the region's largest state-of-the-art service center and auto body shop. That makes Cold Springs your destination for all things camping. Remember, at Cold Springs RV, the doors are always open so you can freely browse. So go check out the latest 2020 models and see for yourself. If you're looking for a pre-owned RV, you'll also find one of the largest selections in New England. Don't miss the year's best selection and early bird savings at Cold Springs RV. And tell them how we sent you. Cold Springs RV, Route 114 in Ware, New Hampshire. Online at ColdSpringsRV.com.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
If Mr. Gunnar was a person, what college would she attend?
The U.S. Coast Guard Academy.
Is Mr. Gunnar a conservative or a Democrat?
Mr. Gunnar is a fiscal conservative and a social liberal.
If you could have dinner with any president, dead or alive, who would it be?
Calvin Coolidge. He was from Massachusetts, and I liked his attitude towards public sector unions, and he said the business of America is business. He's my guy.
Other than yourself, Which columnist do you respect the most?
The late George Frazier. He was a columnist for the Boston Herald, the Boston Globe. Most people have forgotten him now. Jimmy Cannon was pretty good. He was so good that Mike Barnicle used to steal stuff from him all the time. Breslin was good in his early days, not so good later on, but when he was working for the Herald Tribune back when I was a kid in New York, he was damn good.
Biden might be the front runner for the Democrats, but that isn't stopping him from serving up a whole lot of gaffes. Take a listen.
I believe that the president is literally an existential threat to America for three reasons. One, he is a genuine threat to our...
I had permission to hug Lonnie.
He says, let's make America great again. Let's make America America again.
I think I'm either low IQ or slow, or I don't know what I am, you know. Slow Joe Biden.
The thanks for the Mary and I'm gonna be here a lot.
I want the press to know she pulled me close. I just want you to know, okay?
President Trump inherited an economy from Obama Biden.
By the way, he gave me permission to touch him.
They can't even figure out how to deal with the fact that they have this great division between the China Sea and the mountains in the east, in the west.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. You get a lot of patients, I'm sure, who are apprehensive about veneers. What are some of the questions and fears you get when you're dealing with new patients?
Some people think they could look too fake, but true cosmetic dentistry is incredibly detail-oriented. So we put a lot of time and effort into individualizing how the smile looks, and we really make them look natural, but very, very pleasant.
You know, people are concerned. They wonder, I got my teeth. Do I really want to put caps on?
Exactly. Yeah, they think they'll have that Hollywood look or fake look, but the technology that we have available and the artistry that we can create now really makes things so natural that most people, in fact, most dentists are just surprised that we can create what we can create nowadays. Everyone is different. Everyone has different facial dimensions, different bone structure, and we do everything we can to individualize treatment because there is no one perfect smile. It is your perfect smile.
Dr. Houghton, where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE, 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Out of all of your books, which is your favorite title and why?
I think my favorite title is Hitman because it's very effective. I thought long and hard about it. We're going to make it Boston Hitman, but then why make it Boston Hitman? Just make it Hitman. Make it a universal subject.
If you could have dinner with one author, dead or alive, who would it be?
I would probably have dinner with William Shakespeare. I know that's a cliche response, but he was the greatest writer in the English language. No question about it.
If you won Mega Millions, would you retire completely?
I used to say, no, I would not retire. But yeah, I think I would retire now.
If you had to leave all of your money to one charity, which would it be?
The Salvation Army. I like what the Salvation Army does. I don't think they have too many highly paid executives trying to be social justice warriors.
He's New England's talk radio king. He's Howie Carr.
The only French term I like is sans culotte, without trousers. I used to describe Ted Kennedy as sans culotte because after the O'Barr incident, when he was wandering around down on the beach with his 20th scotch tumbler of the day in his hand, stumbling around with an arm. He was just there, as the Michelle Cassone, Patches Date said, he was just there. Without trousers, or as we say in Paris, sans culotte.
We've seen nothing that we can work, that I can work with President Bush on, and I'm disappointed because I thought that there might be some interest because of what he said in the campaign.
President Bush, this is your brain. This is your brain on Botox, okay? That's the lesson of that one.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show. And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate.
Howie Carr.
You have any pets when you were younger?
I had a cat named Dexter. That was my first pet. And then I had possession of two poodles when I lived in Palm Beach, Princess and Frisky. They weren't really my dogs, but I took care of them. They lived with me. So they were my dogs. I love those poodles.
When you were a kid, what was the best gift you ever received?
I got this wooden fort from FAO Schwartz in Palm Beach about the age of 6 or 7. 10 soldiers to go along with it. Such a cool fort. I had that fort for like maybe close to 10 years.
What is your all-time favorite movie?
Probably Goodfellas. I love Goodfellas. I love it even more than The Godfather.
What is your favorite dessert?
Oh, that's a tough one. Probably chocolate ice cream, followed by vanilla ice cream, followed by coffee ice cream.
The Subaru of New England, Washington's birthday sales event lasts all month long. Feel the freedom in the all-new all-wheel drive 2020 Subaru Outback with standard LED headlights. Starting at only $26,645 with 0.9% financing for up to 48 months. Or lease for only $249 per month for 36 months with $2,449 due at signing. Details at SubaruofNewEngland.com.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Who was your favorite actor?
Humphrey Bogart, no doubt about it. I love all the old Humphrey Bogart movies. Jimmy Cagney would be a close second.
Do you have a celebrity crush?
No celebrity crushes.
Ginger or Marianne?
I always was a Marianne person. Never was bowled over by that Hollywood look. Plus, Ginger was in more revealing attire, scantily clad.
Salty or sweet?
Neither, but if I have to pick, I'll go with sweet.
Movies or TV?
TV.
McDonald's or Burger King?
McDonald's, although I'd prefer Five Guys.
Facebook or Twitter?
Definitely Twitter. I hate Facebook.
Cake or pie?
I'm a cake guy.
Coke or Pepsi?
Diet Coke.
Coffee or tea?
Coffee, obviously.
Winter or summer?
Summer. Good Lord. Why would you want winter? It's cold and it's dark.
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
I plan on trying to win New Hampshire. I'm not here to come in second.
Both Elizabeth Warren and Joe Biden will not meet that 15% threshold. And as a result, they will be shut out of pledged delegates in the state of New Hampshire tonight.
We're going to be back in New Hampshire. We're going to be back there to defeat Donald Trump in November.
Nobody under 10% at this point in the process has ever went on to win the nomination and has ever really been, you know, competitive at the end.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
So something has happened in the last 48 hours. People have told me that they're giving Amy Klobuchar a second look.
I wonder why.
I am not going to sugarcoat it. We took a gut punch in Iowa.
You're a lying dog-faced pony soldier.
You cannot have 20, 30, 40, 50 clips in a weapon.
Are you concerned about the message that you're sending to New Hampshire by going to South Carolina?
Not at all. And why are you so negative? Stop getting up on New Hampshire. Don't poke that in my face, okay, buddy?
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
You know, we're counting on having the wind of New Hampshire at our backs. I've got a reservation to fly on to South Carolina tomorrow afternoon.
I am so sorry. That flight is canceled.
Former Massachusetts Governor Deval Patrick is expected to suspend his campaign.
And Diane and I are going to go home and rest and reflect on this outcome.
We're going to be fine.
You know, I am the math guy, and it is clear tonight from the numbers that we are not going to win this race. I am suspending my campaign for president.
Unchained and unstoppable.
President Trump last night had the highest voter turnout of any incumbent in 4 decades. He also had the highest percent of the vote of any incumbent in the past 4 decades. The enthusiasm's on President Trump's side. Democrats, by the way, have a dumpster fire.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
844-500-4242. That's the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. We're going to try to take a lot of calls this hour. So there's so much news going on. We haven't been taking as many calls recently, but we're going to take more calls. But we do have an inordinate amount of sound to get to, and a lot more of a Biden little misstep, shall we say. But we've got a lot to get to. 844-500-4242. Let me just finish this Klobuchar story here. And again, the most famous Klobuchar story with her help is she was flying to South Carolina. This was 2008. And her aide was bringing her a meal to eat on the plane. So he came on to the flight. He was late. He was carrying all the luggage, of course. So he had his hands full. So he had the salad in a bag. And so he hands it to the senator. And she notices there's no utensils to eat it with. So he looks around, and for some strange reason, there's no forks or knives on the plane. That seems weird, but I guess that's the way it was. No one disputes the story. And so she gets really angry, and she takes out a comb and eats the salad with her comb. And then when she finishes eating the salad, she throws the comb at the aide and tells him to clean it so that she can use it in her hair again, which is another kind of weird twist, shall we say, to the story. The rumors about Klobuchar's conduct have circulated for years. This is Vanity Fair. One staffer told BuzzFeed they were coming forward now out of a sense of public duty in advance of her 2020 announcement. The reason it matters is when I hear the descriptors of our current president and how he lacks responsibility and everyone is to blame and there's erratic behavior, name-calling, said the staffer. It's unfortunate, but you're also describing her. That's Amy Klobuchar. You think you'll be hearing about that tonight on MSNBC or...
Howie, it seems like this piece is just combing through her past, and I don't like it.
Yes, it is, Grace. I think it is, Grace. Has someone bought you the new Cheap Bastard deal that we've got going with the massage, Grace?
No,
you were asking for one,
and I really need it. Like Amy Klobuchar, I am stressed out, and lest I get a massage soon, I might start eating things with combs.
Don't throw the comb at me, Grace. We'll try to get you one. If you listen, here's the deal: the gifts, we have gift certificates to the Body Rituals Wellness. It's in Dover, New Hampshire, and you can get a 90-minute massage with CBD oil or toward other services. We have $135 gift certificates for $67.50. That's 50% off. If you don't want the flowers. And the flowers are great for Valentine's Day. Your significant other will love a massage, a 90-minute massage, and it's usually $135 value. You can get it for $67.50. That's a hell of a deal. Their specialty at Body Rituals Wellness is meeting individual needs of each client using a mix of classic and alternative techniques like advanced massage, energy practices, light touch, and deep muscle manipulation therapies to provide each client with a therapeutic and holistic experience that exceeds general expectations of massage and body work. You think your female friends would like that from their boyfriends, Grace? Maybe Grace went away.
Yes, no, they definitely would. And just a tip for everyone. Get this now because you're going to want to be able to say you got something.
Yes.
Otherwise, there might be combs flying in your direction and hair brushes.
And it could, and just print off the receipt from Howie Carr. Go to howiecarshow.com, click on store, order it, and you can print off the receipt. Here, honey, you can have a nice massage in scenic Dover, New Hampshire, in the Seacoast region. All right. 844-500 4242. Joe Biden had a problem with his text number again last night, or almost had a problem with it. Cut number 7, if we've got it.
Chipping and support our campaign. Text Joe 23. Excuse me, I got to get this right. Joe 20330.
And then, as I said earlier, it's like Slaughterhouse Five, the famous line, Billy Pilgrim has come unstuck in time. Joe Biden has come unstuck in time. He's confusing the primaries and the dates and the states. Cut number 9.
The people of Nevada are watching, and I want to make it clear we praise their diversity as a state. And I'm going to be out there seeing them very soon. Tonight, though, we just heard from the first two of 50 states. It's important that Iowa and Nevada have spoken. But look, we need to hear from Nevada and South Carolina and Super Tuesday states and beyond.
Iowa and Nevada have spoken. And now it's important we hear from Nevada and South Carolina. Is there an echo in here from Nevada? Nevada, Nevada. Okay. And again, he's unstuck in time. And here he is misremembering, as George Bush would say, the 2008 campaign, cut eight.
Folks, you know, all those Democrats who won against incumbents from Jimmy Carter to a guy named Clinton, to a guy named Obama, my good friend, guess what? They had overwhelming African-American support. Without it, nobody's ever won. No, really.
No, really. That's not malarkey. He defeated an incumbent, right? Yeah. 844-500-4242. And, you know, sometimes we think that there's a lot of low info voters out there and that they're not paying attention if they're on MSNBC. But they, you know, sometimes they really do figure out what's going on. There was a woman in New Hampshire. This was an interesting exchange with an MSNBC reporter. And, you know, he was doing the usual man in the street. In this case, in New Hampshire, they do a lot of man in the diner. This was a woman, an MSNBC listener, and she's talking about how her vote was influenced. Her vote for Bernie was influenced by the MSNBC coverage. Cut 17.
I want to say the reason I went for Bernie is because of MSNBC. And very
go on.
I think it is completely cynical to say that he's lost 50% of his vote from the last time when there were two candidates. Now there are multiple wonderful candidates who would be great presidents and people that we can unify and get behind. But the kind of the stop Bernie cynicism that I heard from a number of people, I watch MSNBC constantly. So I heard that from a number of commentators. And so that just, it made me angry. I said, okay, Bernie's got my vote.
Keep talking. Bernie will be getting more and more votes. That's the lesson of that. 844-500-4242. That is the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. Something I look forward to every month is my shipment from Butcher Box. The box I got this month came with, as always, ground beef. I love the ground beef. I use it for meat sauce this time of year. I use it for hamburgers on the grill in the warm weather months up north. I get filet mignon. I get the chicken tenders. I get the boneless chicken breasts. They're all organic and free-range chicken. It's so much better. We get the salmon from Bristol Bay. This is a free. This is not farm-raised salmon. This is a wild salmon. It tastes a lot better. Believe me, it's a whole different experience. The bacon is fantastic. Anything you get from Butcher Box and the whatever your favorite steak is, porterhouse, sirloin strip, ribeye, they've got the best. And let me know what you think when you order it. Post a picture of your favorite and how you cooked it to your social media and tag me and Butcher Box and tell us how you prepared it. I did it last week with the chicken tenders. We made it with mushrooms and rice, poached it. It was fantastic. And we tweeted it out and, you know, tag us. And so we can see how you do it. For those of you who are still on the fence about whether to order Butcher Box, let me just tell you, Butcher Box delivers 100% grass-fed, organic, and free-range meat with no antibiotics or hormones ever, right to your door. With free shipping, ButcherBox is the most convenient way to get meat the way it's meant to be. Natural, fresh, and delicious. And to make things better, ButcherBox is offering new members two free filet mignons, and that's the best steak in my opinion. One pack of bacon, and that's you've never had bacon like this if you just buy in the supermarket, and $20 off your first box when you sign up at ButcherBox.com/Howie. That's ButcherBox.com/Howie for two filet mignons, a pack of bacon, and $20 off your first box. ButcherBox.com/Howie. I'm Howie Carr.
Keep it here. The captain will be back after this.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by the Howie Carr Show podcast. Did you miss any hours of our show? Go to Apple, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts and download any episode for free.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
So now you've broken your elbow. Have you ever broken any other bones?
When I was 8 years old, I broke my leg. I was playing touch football in Portland, and a big kid, a 15-year-old, tackled me. When I was in my 30s, I was going down the stairs, and one of the kid's toys was on the stairs, and I tripped on it and broke my foot. I lost a tooth playing touch football when I was just out of Deerfield. I got smacked in the jaw. My tooth went up, and I still have a bridge, a crown from that mishap. I have a replacement hip, and now I have a bunch of pins in my left elbow.
When do you plan to retire?
I don't plan on retiring. As an old football coach once said, once you retire, there's only one big moment left. You know what that is. Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally met rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
If you could go back in time and give your younger self advice, what would you say?
Get a steady job, because behind the job comes the pension.
What's the best advice anyone's ever given you?
Most advice is pretty forgettable.
What's the best money you've ever spent?
The investment I made to leave the corporate radio prison I was in. The worst people I ever worked for, no doubt about it.
So are they going to, does he know that we're still working for them?
If you were on a deserted island and you could only bring three things, what would you bring?
A radio, a Wi-Fi system, obviously, and a computer. And I would bring some books. Don't ask me which books, too hard a question.
What was your dad's job when you were growing up?
My dad worked as a resort hotel manager. He worked in Florida at the Breakers in the winter, and then he worked at the Mountain View House, as it was called then, in Whitefield, New Hampshire, and various other places.
This is Paul in North Andover, Mass.
This is Luana in Lexington, Massachusetts.
This is Lauren in Augusta, Maine, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company that I trust. Give them a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Which dog would you have voted for to win the Westminster Dog Show? Seba the Standard Poodle or Daniel the Golden Retriever?
Seba.
12% say Seba.
I'll tell you, if Whitey Bulger was still around, there wouldn't be 12%. Be a little more than 12% if you knew what was good for you, even though he had miniature poodles, not standard poodles. All right. 844-500-4242. I want to play some Cynthia Nixon. Cynthia Nixon is she was the star of that show, Sex in the City. She was one of the supporting actresses, I guess you'd say, or one of the minor leads. And she ran for governor of New York. And I thought about, you know, I thought, would I vote for her? And then I thought, yeah, I would against Cuomo. I don't like Cuomo. But then she'd say something stupid. And I'd say, what am I going to do? I don't know what I would have done if I was living in New York. But anyway, now she's campaigning with Bernie Sanders. So this is Cynthia Nixon. I think last night at the victory celebration in New Hampshire, cut 34.
Because of Bernie Sanders and because of what he has spent his life doing and how he has changed this country in the last 4 years, he has taught me and he has taught us as a country what we can ask for. We have made do with crumbs for so long.
Crumbs.
And Bernie crumbs. Has said, hey, we're starving in this country. We can't subsist on these crumbs anymore. Why can't we demand the whole pie? And that's what we're doing. That's what we're going to get when Bernie Sanders is our next president.
Give me some pie. I want the whole pie. The Jeffersons only wanted a slice of pie, but I want the whole pie. And so does Cynthia Nixon. That was the 70s. It was enough to get a piece of the pie. Now we're going to get the whole pie. The whole pie. Lee, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Lee.
Well, I hope it's pecan. I like pecan. Hey, you know, if it's free, it's for me. Howie, I watched Steyer walk into VB's interview and first thing out of Steyer's mouth was, what's the VB stand for? Well, he doesn't give the same story you do. Let me just tell you that.
Yeah. Well, you can trust me, Lee. I'm not like the others.
So after he was doing Tulsi and Tulsi's crew and we're moving out, and one of the kids goes, VB. I go, yeah, you want to know what it stands for? And they all turn around. I said, Virgin Boy. But that's not why I called. I says, I went to vote, and there was this perfectly choreographed bunch of kids on the lawn where I vote, and they had signs, and they were all waving, and they were chanting, and they were all in rhythm, and it was, you know, whatever, it was loud. And I'm like, jeez, boy, are they enthusiastic, all for Buttigieg, Buttigieg, Buttigieg. So I go down to the bus, and I see the kids heading for the bus. They're going in shifts. I go, hey, where are you guys from? Marist High School in New Jersey. What the heck are they doing up here?
Marist, is that a Catholic high school, right?
Yeah. I said college, because that's in New York, right?
Yeah.
And the kid goes, the handler goes, no, we're from Marist College, New Jersey. Marist High School, New Jersey. I said, are you voting? So I took a picture of the license. They go, oh, no, we're not voting. We're all high school kids. Who the heck would truck them up here?
I don't get the feeling, too, that Buttigieg is a real... I know he claims he's a Christian, but he doesn't seem to be that much of a First Amendment guy, if you know what I mean, you know? And he wants to legalize heroin and methamphetamines. I mean, I don't know. I don't know what a Catholic, what anybody from a Catholic high school would be supporting him for. That's weird. All right. Thanks for the call, Lee. That's interesting. George, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, George.
Yeah, Howie, how are you? So, you know, it's interesting because, you know, Biden's definitely done. Warren's definitely done because she's just a Me Too. So we have Bernie. He's not, that's why Carville is scared to death of him, right?
Yeah.
Because of what the clip you just played. So Carville should be scared. So now you really got Buttigieg and Klobuchar. Klobuchar doesn't even have a nickname from Trump yet, right? Because she really hasn't been in the ether. I mean, she's now just getting a little oxygen in the room.
Yeah.
So once some of the stuff comes out, like you're talking about, you know, it may be enough to do her in. But if I had to pick everyone right now out of it, I would say Klobuchar as the president, and I would pick, you know, Buttigieg is the VP, right? Because he'll get a few LGBT votes. She'll get maybe some of the women vote, but she's just not that she's just not that much of a socialist yet. But we just haven't vetted her yet.
Did you think she was that impressed? Opinion. Did you watch any of the debate on Friday night? They said she really shone in the debate, but wasn't it just the fact that the others were so lackluster?
No, in some really bad English, she's the least worst of them all because she's not.
Exactly. That's a good way to put it. Right. Yeah. I didn't, but I guess that was enough. That was enough in this debate and this primary. Thanks for the call, George. We'll take some more calls when we come back. I'm Howie Carr. I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. Dr. Houghton, tell us about the state-of-the-art procedures that can help many people look 10 to 15 years younger.
As we age, we do lose these proper proportions to our faces. And so if you're deficient in your chin or mid-face, we can create the proper proportions and make you look great. Sometimes we use orthodontics to change the look of the face. Sometimes we just use the teeth themselves, and it creates the right support for a beautiful face. They're all non-surgical procedures.
There's some pretty complex cases that you deal with. Give me an example of a tough case.
Well, some cases, people just are missing a lot of teeth. I get a lot of people that come in and think that I cannot solve their problems because they're too great, but I really can. We've been doing this for over 35 years, and there isn't much that we haven't seen.
So even if you're missing a few teeth, or your teeth are discolored, or you're very embarrassed, there's no reason not to come in for a consultation, right?
Absolutely. New techniques, new technology, things are available to us that we never had before, and we can handle just about everything.
Where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE.
Joe Biden might be running for president in 2020, so we should play some of his greatest hits.
Barack and I finally reduced the disparity in sentencing, which we've been fighting to eliminate, in crack cocaine versus powder cocaine. Correct. It was a big mistake when it was made. We thought, we were told by the experts that crack, you never go back.
You cannot go to a 7-Eleven or a Dunkin' Donuts unless you have a slight Indian accent.
If you want to protect yourself, get a double barrel shotgun. If there's ever a problem, just walk out on the balcony, put that double barrel shotgun, and fire two blasts.
They're going to put you all back in chains. Give me a break. That's a bunch of malarkey.
The three-letter word, jobs. J-O-B-S, jobs.
One man stands ready to deliver change we desperately need. A man I'm proud to call my friend. A man who will be the next president of the United States, Barack America.
I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. Dr. Houghton, tell us about the state-of-the-art procedures that can help many people look 10 to 15 years younger.
As we age, we do lose these proper proportions to our faces. And so if you're deficient in your chin or mid-face, we can create the proper proportions and make you look great. Sometimes we use orthodontics to change the look of the face. Sometimes we just use the teeth themselves, and it creates the right support for a beautiful face. They're all non-surgical procedures.
There's some pretty complex cases that you deal with. Give me an example of a tough case.
Well, some cases. People just are missing a lot of teeth. I get a lot of people that come in and think that I cannot solve their problems because they're too great, but I really can. We've been doing this for over 35 years, and there isn't much that we haven't seen.
So even if you're missing a few teeth, or your teeth are discolored, or you're very embarrassed, there's no reason not to come in for a consultation, right?
Absolutely. New techniques, new technology, things are available to us that we never had before, and we can handle just about everything.
Where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Would you say you're more like your mom or your dad?
No, I don't think I ended up being like either of them, now that I think about it. My mother worked hard, but she never really learned how to make a lot of money. And my father didn't work so hard, but he had a good personality. He was good with people. He was better than me with people. That's why I'm saying I'm not like either one of them, I don't think.
Did you have any siblings?
Yes, I have a brother, a younger brother.
What was your favorite subject in school?
Well, all kinds of history. I loved all kinds of history.
If you could have three houses besides the ones you already have anywhere in the world, where would they be?
I wouldn't mind having another house in Palm Beach on Clark Avenue. Maybe a place in southern Maine. I don't need a third place.
Didn't you already have a house in Maine?
I did. It was on an island. It was not a good fit for the mailroom manager.
I've heard the house was haunted. Is that true?
Yes. And, my wife didn't really care that much for my relatives.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
We went to the White House for the Christmas party. In your opinion, what was the highlight?
The highlight of my trip to the White House with Grace, there were two. Number one, when we walked into Trump International Hotel, which she'd been dreaming of going to, and her eyes were wide. And then when the president actually came down the stairs, her eyes were even wider. She was so in awe of being there. I really felt like King Farouk, you know? I felt like I was giving someone a really great gift that they couldn't get otherwise.
You've had some really good interviews over the years. Which one was your favorite?
I can't really say what the best interview I ever had, but one that just occurred to me was Jesse Helms, the senator from North Carolina. I interviewed him one time, and he went to high school with my mother in Monroe, North Carolina. And the first words out of his mouth were, "Howie, I know your mother before you knew your mother."
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
844.
You know, I am the math guy, and it is clear tonight from the numbers that we are not going to win this race. I am not someone who wants to accept donations and support in a race that we will not win. And so tonight, I am announcing I am suspending my campaign for president.
Oh, no.
I love you, Andrew!
I love you, too. Thank you, Andrew.
I love you, Andrew. I wanted to get $1,000 a month from you when you were elected president. He was big on the internet, not so big at the precincts level in New Hampshire yesterday. So we were playing some of Katie Turr's greatest hits in commemoration of her fine performance last night in New Hampshire, where she lamented the fact that her generation has to take out 30-year loans to buy cars. But that's not the first stupid thing that she's said. Earlier this month, she talked about how the Senate needed to be gerrymandered. Gerrymandered. Gerrymandering the Senate. I don't know how you would do that. No, she doesn't know either. But anyway, we've got a couple other of her greatest hits. This is from a year ago. She was talking, I guess this was around President's Day, cut 29.
Happy President's Day.
You know, it is George Washington's Day here, Washington Day here in New York, unlike the rest of the country, because George Washington, native son of New York.
Big up, big New Yorker.
That's right.
East Coast. He was known as an East Coast one.
He was New York's big papa.
What a fool. What did she think, that because the George Washington Bridge is in New York, that makes him a native son? Did she ever hear of Mount Vernon? Of course not. Okay, here, let's play cut 31. This is from 2018.
No. And also, I will say, and we got to go, unfortunately, mm-hmm. but in the at the Republican National Convention, the Republican Party decided not to arm Ukraine.
But Ukraine is armed, J.K.
They are armed. So that you could argue that. Well, I don't know.
I don't know. I don't know. I just said it because it's a Democrat talking point. It came into my email today from the DNC. So I said it. It's not true, but what the heck? Okay. So here she's going to get fact checked again. This one's a little longer. This is about Claire McCaskill and her vote for a Supreme Court justice. Cut 30.
McCaskill voted for Gorsuch, did not vote for Kavanaugh. In talking about why she didn't vote for Kavanaugh, she had a bit of a different reasoning than most Democrats did. Here's her statement. I've been thorough in examining Judge Kavanaugh's record, and while the recent allegations against him are troubling and deserve a thorough and fair examination by the Senate Judiciary Committee, my decision is not based on those allegations, but rather on his positions on several key issues. Most importantly, the avalanche of dark anonymous money that is crushing our democracy. What is her vote on Kavanaugh? What is it doing for conservatives?
Well, it's a couple things. On the dark money stuff, she voted for John Roberts, okay? John Roberts had years of jurisprudence supporting the speech rights of. So if it was dark money, she's had a very recent come to Jesus on that.
And live from St. Louis, but hold on, before you start playing that. We have a fact check. That came to us from one of our students here. One of the Republican politicos that we had on earlier said that Claire McCaskill voted for John Roberts. John Roberts wasn't confirmed in 2005. Claire McCaskill was a seat in the Senate until 2007. That is from Dorian right back there. Stay with us.
Good Lord. What a train wreck she is. She doesn't, she gets fact-checked by students on the air. 844-500-4242. That's the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. By the way, I just got to read a couple more things here before we go back to the phone lines. I'm reading a lot more about the Virginia politics and current events since they got this new legislature down there with Democrat majorities for the first time in 15, 20 years. And, you know, they're passing all this anti-gun legislation, and it's just a real mess. And so they had a, they like most legislatures, they have a pastor or a clergyman come in every day and before the session begins to deliver a prayer. And there was a big a big controversy yesterday because a black minister came in and he's an evangelical, and he delivered a religious invocation, and the Democrats got very, very excited. Virginia lawmakers, Democrats, lashed out at a pastor who delivered a prayer at the House of Delegates, urging them not to induce God's anger and wrath while pushing through a chain of liberal bills. Reverend Robert M. Grant Jr., pastor of the Father's Way Church in Warrenton, Virginia, used his opportunity to speak out against a host of legislative initiatives involving homosexual marriage and abortion. During his prayer, Reverend Grant urged lawmakers in Virginia to stand for what was right within the eyes of God. You can see where they're getting excited, the delegates. Please do not provoke his anger and bring wrath upon this commonwealth by what you create as law, Grant stated. Biblical history is very clear. His wrath upon the earth is documented. We are not exempt. He then told the delegates, again, this is the state where Governor Northam, the Klansman governor, has said that even though he's a pediatrician by trade, he wants to have infanticide is what it amounts to. He didn't call it infanticide. He told delegates, the reverend told delegates, all life is precious and worthy of a chance to be born. Every one of you sitting here today can guarantee these rights to all the little innocent children of Virginia, Grant added. And why are there so many abortion clinics near African-American communities? This is planned urban genocide, and you can change this. And then he talked about biblical definitions of marriage. Marriage is to join a biological male and a biological female in holy matrimony, Grant stated, not to provoke the wrath of Almighty God. It was at this point that Speaker Eileen Filler-Corn banged her gavel while the Democrat delegates were walking out, and she cut him off and began the Pledge of Allegiance. Defending his remarks outside, Reverend Grant said, I feel the State House belongs to all of the voters, and all of the voters have a choice. If I'm a pastor, what are you expecting from me? If you do not need to listen to what a pastor has to talk about, why did you invite me? He was invited by a Republican, obviously. Here's one other story from Virginia that I thought was pretty funny today. And again, I'm just reading more Virginia stories just to see what's going on down there as the new Democrat legislature tries to repeal the Bill of Rights. Authorities, deputies confront man wearing Ku Klux Klan robe. Stafford Courthouse, Virginia. A man seen wearing a Ku Klux Klan robe and a hood at a Virginia shopping center Tuesday told sheriff's deputies he was performing a social experiment, according to authorities. They saw this guy walking around with a Klan robe. They said, we didn't know the governor was going to be in town.
The Ku Klux Klan is the Ku Klux Klan.
You know, Governor Northam, there's a picture of him in his medical school yearbook. He's in blackface in one picture, or he's wearing a Klan outfit. He's never been made it clear which one he is. Is he the guy in blackface or the Klansman? It turns out it was a black man who was wearing the Klan outfit, not Governor Northam. Or could have been Governor Northam in blackface wearing the Klan outfit. They went to the Target in the Stafford marketplace around 2:30 p.m. to investigate reports of a Klansman. Deputies found the Klansman, identified him as a black man, and determined he didn't live in the area. What has that got to do with the price of tomatoes? Deputies warned him about wearing a mask in public, and he left the scene. Virginia law prohibits wearing masks with the intent to conceal identity in public. I wonder if that applies to Antifa, too. A photo posted to Twitter by a witness showed someone dressed in the Klan outfit, favored by the governor, talking to deputies while others looked on. Again, I mean, it's very confusing in Virginia, you know. I mean, you see a guy walking around in a Klan outfit in a shopping mall, and it could be the governor, and it could be a black guy, or it could be the governor in blackface. Ron, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Ron.
Hey, I've been wanting to do this for a long time. How are you, Captain?
Good.
I might need the voice changer there, Howie, because, you know, I was up in the.
Okay. Well, hold on. Let's make sure we can turn on the voice changer. It takes a little while. You know, the voice changer is the witness protection program of the Howie Carr Show. As you can see from me talking, once I turn on the voice changer, you cannot recognize the voice of the person speaking. So you're all set now, Ron. You're safe.
So I'm from Duxbury. I had an opportunity last minute to go up and go to the rally. So I did it. You know, I'm a working stiff, so I had to get up at 6 o'clock in the morning and do all my emails and my work so I could leave at 11. I got up there. We got up there with a friend and her son, 38 years old. He's been to four of them. So we parked. We got in at 1:30. Now we got a little wait, but I just wanted to give you some of my observations. I got down on the floor and I was looking for Grace because he got down there and was looking and saw her. And I'm standing there, and this very good-looking, I thought she was a reporter, it was Kaylee McEnany, I think.
Oh, McEnany, yes, yeah.
McEnany, she's married to the baseball player, yeah. Anyway, she's just about to go up on the stage for a spot, and she's looking at me, and I got my phone, I'm looking around, where's Grace? And she says, you're looking for somebody? I said, well, yeah, I was looking for somebody. I said, who are you? She goes, I'm Kaylee. Would you like to take a picture? So I took a picture. I sent it to my 30-something kids, and I go, Dad, you know who that is, you know?
Yeah, we've got actually, Ron, we've got a cut from Kaylee in the today. This is she's bragging about Trump's turnout. Hold on. Here it is. Cut 25.
Go ahead. Go ahead. Yeah.
You know, President Trump last night had the highest voter turnout of any incumbent in four decades. He also had the highest percent of the vote of any incumbent in the past four decades. And when you juxtapose that against Bernie Sanders, who had the lowest vote total of any Democrat nominee in 68 years, it is quite something. The enthusiasm's on President Trump's side. Democrats, by the way, have a dumpster fire. They have a real mess on their side.
Yeah. She was great, Howie. I tell you what, the other general observation is that if you want to go to an event like that with 10,000 people and not get pushed and shoved and have people be polite to you, go to a friggin' Republican thing like that. Because if I was at a Democratic thing, I wouldn't be able to get in line. People wouldn't be nice to me. She says, here, I'll take a selfie with you, a bald-headed 60-something, you know. But I'm telling you, it was a one in a lifetime thing. And then obviously to hear Trump, it was like surreal. I thought I've always thought he's a little bit caustic and a little bit mean. You know what? When you're there, he tells it like it is. He tells the truth. How can you fault that? You know what
right.
I'm saying?
It's like a you know, somebody said who saw him at a Republican gathering down here said it's like you know, one of these you know, inspirational self-help Tony Robbins speeches mixed up with stand-up comic. I mean, you get the best of both worlds together, you know? And it really is an experience. And the fact that, you know, you said that this kid that was there, this is his fourth one. I mean, so many people now are saying this is my, they're tracking these Trump rallies, like people used to in the 80s and 70s used to track Grateful Dead concerts. You know, they follow them around and they go to, you know, they take a couple of days off so that they can just camp out and go to the concert or the rally in this case. And it's really a very big social event. And if you haven't seen one and you have a chance to get to a Trump rally, you really owe it to yourself, because they really are unforgettable experiences. Thanks for the call, Ron. 844-500-4242. I'm Howie Carr.
Don't touch that dial. Howie Carr will be back after this.
This is for my listeners who are still suffering from hair loss and thinning hair. I recently met up with the doctors at New England Center for Hair Restoration, and I was amazed at their consistent results. After hearing my story about hair loss, the doctors agreed to offer the first 40 listeners of my show an initial hair transplant procedure for only $6,000. You heard me right. New England Center for Hair Restoration is offering my listeners this exclusive opportunity to get a hair transplant procedure for the unbelievable price of $6,000. That's a savings of $4,000 for qualifying patients. If you've always wanted a hair restoration and couldn't afford it, New England Center for Hair Restoration is where you want to go. A hair transplant procedure for $6,000 for the first 40 people. This offer won't last long. For those who qualify, third-party financing is available with monthly payments as low as $119. Call 800-313-HAIR for your free consultation. That's 800-313-HAIR. Call 800-313-HAIR.
Whether it's global warming, global cooling, or climate change, one thing's for certain, the progressive moon bats can't stop talking about it.
We're talking about cities all over the world, major cities going underwater.
You know, I've spent a lot of time now with these young students, and they're scared. And a lot of young people are even suffering from, they're calling it extinction illness.
So that we can have people here who truly are committed to climate change, believe in climate change as though it's a religion, it's not a science.
A woman whose dreams of motherhood now taste bittersweet because of what I know about our children's future.
You have stolen my dreams, my childhood, with your empty words.
That curing cancer is going to be much more difficult when there's so much climate change and pollutants in the environment, because a lot of cancer is environmentally caused.
Recognizing and acknowledging the link between animal agriculture and climate change is a very bold move, making tonight plant-based.
John, what happened at Perfect Smiles when you went?
The initial consultation was easy. In the past, they just hand me a clipboard, they fill out the forms, but that's not how I worked at Perfect Smiles. What was nice was it was a true consultation. They asked me my medical history or what I wanted to get out of the treatment plan. For me, I lived with TMJ. I'd literally have to crack my jaw throughout the day to relieve the pressure. I'd get headaches throughout the day. I'd be in pain. When I was at Perfect Smiles, they asked me what I wanted to get out of the treatment. You know, as a joke, I just said, geez, I'd love you to be able to fix my TMJ. And I was surprised, because Dr. Houghton specializes in working with patients like me that have TMJ.
What were the results of visiting Dr. Houghton at Perfect Smiles?
Not only did I walk out of that office with a perfect smile, but he fixed my TMJ. It was a life-changing event. People tell me now that my smile's amazing. People would say, geez, John, your teeth look so great. I never realized my teeth looked so bad before. Now I take a look at the before and after pictures, and I'm amazed.
Go to Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire, or visit their website, perfectsmiles.com.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
You are known as a cheap bastard. Which one of your daughters is the cheapest and why?
Charlotte is the cheapest, and I say that because she's always using my credit card. We keep changing the credit cards over and over again, and she keeps busting in and using them again. Most recently, just this week, she spent $75 at AT&T.
What's the cheapest thing you do now to save money?
The cheapest thing I do currently to save money, I guess, is I take all the bottles and cans back to the market basket every weekend. I always like to save that money. You know, I can't stand to throw those bottles and cans away and have the unclaimed returns go to the state of Massachusetts for illegal aliens.
Do you recycle?
Yes, I do recycle. When I got on the town meeting, I saw that the town dump was probably the only department in the town that was running in the black. And it's because of all the recycling that was going on. So I try to keep my taxes down that way. Is Grace there? Yeah.
This is Lynn in sunny Las Vegas.
This is Dan from the Moonbat capital of Jamaica Plain.
This is Gigi
from Leominster,
Massachusetts, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
Why did you say what you said in that 2015 speech?
I don't think those words reflect what how I led the most diverse city in the nation. And I apologized for the practice and the pain that it caused.
I don't think he answered the question, did he, Mayor Bloomberg?
That was a very deep and long sigh.
What did you mean when you said throw him up against the wall? I mean, whatever you think of stop and frisk, do you really want to be throwing people up against the wall? That's kind of what the DOJ and the FBI were trying to do to the Trump campaign. And we don't really appreciate that, do we, in the United States? And Mayor Bloomberg, when you say 95% of the murders are committed by young black men, really? Have you looked at the FBI crime stats?
But I also love how he says those words don't reflect the diverse or whatever he says. It's like, they're your words. He's acting like he's criticizing a whole different person. We are literally playing your words back to you.
Yeah. You know, when you watch his campaign, though, and you watch his surrogates, these are the best people money can buy, because he's now up to $350 million. You know, his expenditures are like that debt clock they used to have in Times Square. It was just going around and around and around and around and around because we were running up the debt so fast. That's how fast he's spending money. I'm told that, you know, on some of the streams on our radio stations, whenever we go to a break, Grace, it's a Bloomberg ad. I don't know how many stations. They are. They're everywhere. They're on the stream.
He's got Seba the dog, Howie, the dog that just won.
Yeah.
He's voting for Bloomberg.
Talented dog.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to snort. It's been a long day. Guys, I have some really big news for Howie about McDonald's ice cream. But before I tell him that, I want to let everybody know one last time, because I know there's a lot of guys out there listening to the show who have probably been trying to write this down or keep saying, oh, I'll do it tomorrow. Today's the day. Valentine's is just 2 days away. You need to act fast with 1-800-Flowers.com. You can get 24-stem colorful rose medley for only $29.99. Or upgrade, everyone loves an upgrade, to 24 red roses for only $10 more. They're gorgeous. Howie's looking at them right now. They're so beautiful, fresh, full flowers. To order, go to 1-800-Flowers.com and enter code Howie.
There you go.
Okay, so here's the update, Howie. And I know this is going to really mean a lot to you personally.
This is one of my pet peeves, as Grace well knows, as we ride around New England together going to remote events. Sometimes we stop at McDonald's, but there's always a problem, isn't there, Grace?
Yes, and the ice cream machine
is the problem?
Ice cream machine is usually broken. So one of the many things I've learned about Howie while traveling this beautiful country of ours together is his taste in music, his style of dance, which is mostly shoulders like Elizabeth Warren, and also that if an ice cream machine is broken, Howie will freak out. Luckily for him, there's new technology that will prevent the machines from breaking down.
Now there's yet another reason to go to McDonald's. The ice cream machines aren't going to be broken down every time we go there.
Exactly.
See you tomorrow. I'm Howie Carr.
That there is only one Sunday every year that Bank Chevrolet Buick GMC is open. Being closed on Sundays throughout the year is important.